All right, let's get this stuff up and running here. Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the show. I am your host, Fontaman, and we're back with Library of Ruina, wherein we embrace the Second Amendment. We embraced it as a loving child or an old friend. A dear, dear old friend. Okay, so let's see, as soon as we get the game to actually load properly here. There we go. Right. Hello, folks. That shit's old and busted. I'm still wondering what's going on with, the doctor and the nurse there. They're probably still out there. We'll probably see them later. That seemed like it was still going somewhere up there. It's probably not over yet, as horrifying as that sounds. We're probably going to see some ascendant flesh monster crawl out of the warp and try and kill us again. But let's get back to it, folks. Right, okay, so we got Hod Malkuth, which is good because that will probably get us our fourth librarians for each of them. And then on top of that, well, we'll have to... We'll shelve Roland's team for a little bit because they've only got three currently. We'll probably get another one relatively quickly, but... Well, let's get through these first and, see what we can do here, because then we've got a balance here, because we've got Hod, and Hod's bleeding. Excuse me. We got a lot of bleeding cards from Seo, even though we didn't really actually pay attention to her at all. It's kind of a shame, her and her fat tits. We kind of just mowed her down and went about our business. That was actually kind of pathetic. I was expecting a much more threatening fight with how the character acts, and I suppose the cutscene where she gets beat down by a furry in a fucking alley is... It's probably the tip-off that she's not actually that strong, but that was kind of embarrassing. Still a nice design, though, but Jesus fucking Christ, that was easy. But so, we've got bleeding cards from her that we could throw on Hod to make that more advantageous. And then Malkuth, what does Malkuth do again? Okay, it's like stagger damage, get your highest cost in the hand, play pages, uses the same name, will decrease cost every copy of that page. Okay, hang on here. Last cost in a hand is chosen. Right, okay, on play. Mm-hmm. Pages with the same... Using pages with the same name will decrease cost every... Okay, so that's just that one card. That's synergizing with that one card that we have where, you know, it gets cheaper the more we use it, right? I totally forgot what Hod's fucking deal is, unfortunately, except for fire. Power in a clash. All dice lose 1-2 power and one, you know, one-sided attack. Always clash, right. So, we'll be getting new cards here, but, deal bonus stagger damage equal to the dice's value at 20% chance. Okay, that's 20% chance, but that... Does shooting the man dead before he gets a chance to attack count as winning a clash? Because that... We could use that. So, I'm not quite sure what to do with Hod aside from fire, which we would basically steal what we've got on Roland right now and use Salvador's kit and everything else. Hod is just bleeding, or Malkuth, I should say. There's several of you, and they're very hard names. I'll get them eventually. Anyway, right, so, what we're going to do is we're just going to really quick outfit all of these characters with, all of, Netz's equipment. Real quick. Right, where are they? Here we go. Right, so we're just gonna very quickly steal all of the guns. Malkuth does actually look pretty nice as a tactical office lady. Just like that girl's front line. Really. So, as I said, the first question we're going to ask is, can we beat it with just guns? Can we just punch through it with guns? We'll see. I'm predicting that this cheese is not going to go very far on its own, but it's a nice cheese. You really only want one person with gun pages. Cricks, were you here last night where we were shutting down entire fucking encounters with just guns? I mean, yeah, sure. Having one guy as just having guns as support is nice, but let's see how far we can lean into this, because Focus, we absolutely obliterated all of our fucking, you know, all of our encounters. We had to retry once for, you know, Philip and his sudden boss fight, but we got his ass. But let's see. Are you even at the hard part of the game yet? Everyone keeps... I've apparently begun the game. We'll see how this goes. Fairy Festival. Okay, so what the fuck's going on here? All right, yes, this. Right, that. Okay. So passives again. There we go. I had to actually hover over him. Right, momentary sensation. Right, okay. Momentary satiation. Right, my bad. Right, okay, so kill the food and then kill the monster. He hasn't been forced to take a hammer to his ding-dong yet, so no. Thanks, Deku. Right, fun. Philip's boss fight is the first real tough fight, but it's still easier than the clown fight. Yeah, haven't seen him yet, but we'll probably get them. This cheese isn't going to last forever, but we made pretty good work with the cheese. Fun? In this day and age, say it ain't so. Yeah, I know we're done with the power fantasy stuff of the early 2000s. We need to be more Souls-like. We need to be more like Dark Souls. We need to make people work excruciatingly hard for a single ounce of satisfaction, and then that's just one encounter in our game. Modern game design. I mean, yeah, it makes the accomplishments feel like accomplishments, but holy shit, guys, it makes me miss the days of, you know. As I said before, I went back and played Prototype for some writing research, and I was kind of amazed that, yeah, that game is just 100% a power fantasy. And it was quite refreshing! Just like Ace Combat is 100% a power fantasy. Fuck. Ace Combat Zero is a BBC documentary about how fucking cool you are. We don't have this shit anymore. Now we've got Battle Royale games and extraction shooters and Dark Souls. No, we need to work more. I guess we just got bored, and now we need to, I don't know, break our fucking fingers every time we lose to make things a little bit more exciting. But okay, so let's see. Well, we can shoot you. I suppose we'll just try and just focus fire and see how this goes. Because again, I know this isn't gonna work forever, but let's see how far we can shove this. Wow. Ah. Okay, so they have guts. Right, I didn't read the passes for the other guys, so I just wasted a bunch of cards on that. But they have guts. Noted. Okay, so that was unfortunate. But... Oh. Fragile feet. Oh, that... Oh, okay. So when we do that, I see. So that's not a buff. That's actually... They're actually more easy to attack. Okay, so now we focus fire the boss, guys. Let's get in there. Guardsmen to the front. Let's fucking do this. Flick three bridges. Why not? Why would you start an Abno fight without reading? I read the main boss's... passives. I didn't read the minions. At the start of each scene, restore 10 HP. HP does not drop below 1 until the queen dies. I missed that. That's where I fucked up. Yeah. Can we stagger her into oblivion? Yes! Yes! We can, in fact, just stagger her into oblivion. Fantastic. Absolutely just grand. Yes, and you killed all of your minions to regain some health, and now you're even more weak. All right, so yeah, that's just kind of a cascading sort of failure there, where she... Yeah, we weaken one of the minions, she eats them, she gets weaker, we hit her really fucking hard, and then she eats the other minions and gets even fucking weaker. So, basically, snowball. Okay, well, unfortunately, I only have one attack to use here, but all right. I I don't think we're going to need anything, but okay. I really don't think we're really going to need any more assistance on this matter. That 31, holy shit. Also defense rolls. All right. Volume of fire it is. Well, not that it matters, I guess, but... All right, then. This is not gonna work forever, but as you can see, real fucking cheesy for getting through certain situations currently. We will ask this question repeatedly. The first time, first thing we throw out, can we kill it with guns? Yes or no? If yes, all right, moving on. If no, all right, have to think about this. But okay, that's done. Now for more plot. Or rather, character development. Yeah, just thanks full stop for giving us guns that we 3D print ammo for. Therefore, we don't suffer the crippling economic setbacks and issues that operating guns in this universe comes with. It's great to be an absolute cheating bastard.
오늘도 기운 차구만, 말코트. 뭐 하고 있는 거야?
아, 놀랑. 보조사서들과 훈련하는 중이야.
God bless the city and her guns. Training a session with the assistant librarian. Yes, we're brushing up on firearms. I guess Malkuth, heard about that girl's frontline game and, she thought that might be a good thing to specialize in.
분위기 좋은 걸.
Librarian's frontline. Librarian's frontline. What am I thinking? Blue Archive. Library of Ruina. What am I thinking? It's right there in front of me. It's literally slapping me in the face. The only thing it could, you know, it could do more is have bigger tits.
로보토미 때 함께했던 직원들이니까. 그때는 직원들과 함께 있어주지 못하고 뒤에서 보조만 했어. 이번에는 함께 할 수 있어서 좋아.
It's nice to spend some time in the trenches again.
예전 로보토미사의 직원들이라 감회가 새롭겠네.
맞아. 그리고 예전에는 내 잘못으로 인해 직원들을 심하게 몰아세웠어.
Doesn't Blue Archive also have the weird mythic names too? Yes, it is a massive biblical allegory. So yeah, that. Yo, this yo. Project Moon's fucking absolute love affair with the Tree of Life and biblical reference. Yeah, this works.
하지만 이번에는 달라. 할 수 있는 것부터 차근차근히 하려고 해. 과거를 직면하여 미래를 만들어라. 역사를 관통하는 문장인 것 같아 마음에 들었어.
That wasn't the tagline of the game, though, but we'll pretend that that was actually correct. If I remember, it was Face to Fear, Build the Future. That didn't look terribly good on mugs, even though, you know, some people enjoyed that. Some of the more, darker Spartan people of the, you know, of the company enjoyed that line, but that, it didn't really float well with marketing.
맞는 말이야. 하지만 역사를 통해 배울 수 있는 사람은 드물지.
It's even better when people completely fucking ignore history and pretend none of that shit applies to us.
옛날 일들에 대해 많이 생각해봤어. 나는 엘리야라는 사람이었어.
This is where we're gonna learn everybody's names now.
너의 첫 번째 삶?
Elijah, isn't that a... To throw the Zeta Gundam references on its head, isn't that a boy's name?
응. 평범하게 도시의 둥지에서 자라 평범하게 공부를 하며 학교를 다녔지. 특별할 것도 없었어. 돈이 특별하게 더 많은 것도 재능이 특출난 것도 아니었으니까. 엘리야가 살던 둥지의 사람들은 다들 어딘가 초점을 잃고 허공만 바라보는 것 같았어. 도시에서 하얗고 검은 것만 보고 있었지.
Everything got really, really, really kind of boring, and everything went grayscale as the director's way of articulating how monotonous life had become. Great cinematography there.
하지만 둥지는 번쩍이고 화려한 빛깔들로 가득하지 않나? 가끔 눈이 아플 정도로 현란하던데.
그건 그렇지만 사람이 글자를 읽는 데에 다른 색은 필요 없었거든. 희고 검은 것을 다 담기도 벅찬데 쓸데없는 색까지 눈에 담을 여유가 없다고.
Okay, so you're all really boring fuckers, but you really, really, really attempt to spruce up the place, but you guys don't even believe in this shit either, huh? Wow. I'm starting to see why there are so many absolutely, you know, driven psychopaths out there, because the Nessus just seems to be filled with morons that just get astoundingly bored with everything and have to go to greater and greater lengths to entertain themselves. Seems a lot of people choose murder. Murder seems like a good way of spicing things up, right? Starting to see that pattern out there, right?
그렇다는 건 엘리아는 색을 볼 수 있었나 보지?
볼 수 있다기보다는 보려고 했던 거지.
Dystopian post-apocalypse
색이
does that to people.
처음부터 아예 없는 건 아니었어.
Surviving the apocalypse in relative comfort, really takes a hit to the soul when you realize, wow, it's all downhill from here. And even though I've survived in comfort, shit's gonna get really fucking dull and boring for years, decades before we recover. Man, how will I spice things up? Murder is apparently what a lot of people in this universe choose. Murder. Guns for hire, all these sorts of things. Becoming scientists with no sense of right and wrong. All these things, man.
엘리아는 사람들에게 알려주고 싶었어.
If we recover, right? Yeah, there's also that if thing. But unfortunately, this is kind of set back by the whole people getting really bored and choosing murder and morally bankrupt science for entertainment purposes. Well, entertainment and also progress, air quotes. Progress. Recovery at any cost. It kind of works against the whole recovery thing at the end. Everybody just, kind of goes out and does amoral horseshit, and then we just become the Eldar, and then we have an even worse fucking apocalypse down the line.
색이란 게 얼마나 다채롭고 눈이 부신지.
Yes, Malkuth, tell everyone how pretty the Eye of Terror is. They won't believe you until it blows open the sky and kills most of the human population, but tell everyone how pretty it looks.
서로 다른 색이 만나면 새로운 색이 탄생하는 것처럼 끝없이 자유롭게 변화할 수 있는 게 바로 색이라고.
And the god of sad panda tags. But again, no one's gonna believe you until it actually happens.
엘리아는 그런 생각을 했던 것 같아.
Oh, so we're talking about colors a lot now, I see. As we brought in the fucking rainbow code, like grade zero elite fucking operatives. Talking a lot about colors all of a sudden. You notice that? It's become a kind of a narrative theme we're circling around with this part of the game. Colors.
꼭 남의 이야기를 하는 것처럼 말하네.
Yeah, you notice that, Roland? You notice how everybody's here is treating their human selves, their first lives, as a completely different fucking person? I mean, I can see how having three tries at the whole thing would make you a bit distant and pedestrian to your own life, but you're talking about yourself, remember, right?
솔직히 엘리아와 내가 동일한 존재라고 느껴지진 않아.
Yeah, about that. Go on, explain.
많은 시간이 흘러서일까?
Yeah, so it is basically what I just said. All right, right. It's just, it's been too long. I've had too many retries of the thing. Me who finished the tutorial and me now, we're just two different fucking people, man.
다른 사서들도 모두 그럴 거야. 오히려 내 삶은 로보토미에서 부여받은 두 번째 삶인 말쿠트에서 이어져 온 것만 같아. 그래서 첫 번째 삶인 엘리아는 어딘가 좀 낯설어. 그랬던 사람이 내 안에 있다는 느낌?
You are different people. The current you is enlightened by guns. Ah, yes. I enjoy the Second Amendment and express my rights as an American citizen. I vote Republican. I am enlightened. I am trans.
그리우면서도 서글프고 그러네.
Or in this case, everyone here would say I am a toaster because apparently life as a toaster was more memorable than life as a human. But I suppose, hey, guys, why is it that the memories of our past selves in human life are less resonant and less important than our lives as a toaster in Lobotomy Corp? Oh, right, maybe because that was the first game and our human selves didn't get a game. Shit, we didn't even get the fucking prologue. Though, unfortunately, it doesn't look like there'd be any gameplay to that one. We can't have the... Whatchamacallit, the whole, bakery girls thing for Girls Frontline to go all the way fucking back in the before times. But, eh. I mean, we saw a bunch of flashbacks in Lobotomy Corp, which is kind of funny. But, oh well, I guess those don't really matter. Yeah, no, Toaster Life was just, it was really great.
난 잘 모르겠지만.
It wasn't pretty. A lot of things in Lobotomy Corp's writing were just incredibly edgy. And not pretty by default. This is more refined in terms of what they're doing with their grimdark, setting. But it's got a bit of class to it. And it got a little bit of a balance to it. It still goes into incredibly edgy shonen, anime-isms. Like I'm watching, shit on Adult Swim or Anime Unleashed. But it's got a bit more presentability to it. It's a little bit more upstanding in its... edgy as fuckness. It's balanced a little bit more.
Mm. 그렇게 나쁜 기분은 아니야.
Yeah, being a toaster is great.
이제서야 나를 돌아볼 수 있는 여유가 생긴 것 같아. 내가 살아온 날들 말이야.
Yeah, right. Yeah, what happens when you actually live by the statement I'll rest when I'm dead.
우리는 되돌아보는 시간이 너무 부족했어. 너무 앞만 보고 달려왔으니까.
Yes, we were all spending way too much time looking forward towards the future, chasing really questionable objectives and becoming ever more morally bankrupt along the way. Nah, no reflection, only progress. Shh, we're not at hag love time yet. Oh, right, we still haven't gotten to that one. I still gotta see this one, because Deku's infatuated with old hags because of this. We'll see, because the game's gotta sell me this one.
그리고 어쩌면 엔젤라도...
다들 되돌아볼 여유가 없지. 난 지금도 앞만 보고 달리고 있거든.
Yeah, unfortunately, sometimes there's just too many fucking problems to fix, eh, Roland?
그래도 말이야. 지금 당장이 막막하거나 미래가 걱정스러울 때 과거를 돌아보면 해결책을 찾을 수 있다더라고.
Some of the times, if you actually pay attention, hags with malicious intent. Yes, hags with malicious intent and threatening auras. Welcome to Library of Arena.
그런 것 같아. 지금 당장의 문제들을 해결할 만한 건 잘 모르겠지만.
I have a solution. Firearms. We call up Colt.
엔젤라가 했던 말에 대한 대답은 어느 정도 찾은 것 같거든.
네가 누구였고 어떻게 살고 싶었는지에 대해?
맞아. 그때 당시에는 꿈이라고 할 게 없었지만.
But now I wanna dress up in tactical gear and own firearms and post selfies of myself on the internet. She's got a bright future.
지금은 달라. 내가 만약 이 이후에 무슨 일을 할지 꿈꿀 수 있다면 난 건축가를 하고 싶지 않았을까 싶어. 건물을 설계하고 완성까지 모든 것을 총 책임지고 지휘하는 사람 말이야.
Building buildings.
건물은 그냥 뚝딱뚝딱 지어내는 게 아닌가 보네.
그렇지. 기능적으로 만들어낼 수 있는 최대치에서 가장 아름다운 외관을 생각하는 것부터 시작해야 하니까.
복잡한 거였구만.
그거 알아, 놀람? 사람이 건물을 만들지만 나중에는 건물이 사람을 만든다는 말. 새로 태어날 사람들이 이 도시의 건축물을 보고 자라면 어떤 영향이 갈까? 만약 내가 모든 사람의 기억에 남을 색이 담긴 건물을 만든다면 그런 생각이 드네.
Right. Hey guys, maybe if we made very colorful and expressive buildings, people will remember. Oh right, morals are a thing.
말쿠트 너라면 잘 해낼 수 있을 것 같은데? 어울리기도 하고.
고마워.
Yes, all great thoughts for pursuit after the war is over. Whenever the war is over. The war's never over. Service to the emperor is a never-ending task.
롤랑 너도 나처럼 과거에 대해서 다시 한번 돌아보면 좋을 것 같아.
난 늘 뒤를 돌아보고 있지.
My wife is dead!
어쨌든 건축가의 꿈을 이룰 수 있다면 좋겠네.
오케이. Assistant librarian awoken. More abnormality pages. So what's the new abnormality pages? Okay, what do we... Okay, fairy's care... What? For three scenes, recover 15% of max HP. Max 18 at the end of the scene. If the librarian is hit three times while the effect is active, lose 25% of current HP, max 30, and loses effect. Yeah, that sounds nice, aside from the whole fact of I can't control that. Well, I can with clashes, I suppose, but that's... that's a hell of a fucking caveat for emergency medical, medical care. Basically, redirect all attacks from... If you can, if you get enough dice to do that. Fairies were no more than carnivorous monsters, and their protection was their method to keep the meat fresh. Yeah, that's, When attacking a target who already took damage on the same scene, deal 1+3 damage and recover 2-5 HP. That's actually really fucking good for slamming people with guns. That's useful. I like that. When you hit somebody, if you're focusing fire, everybody gets to do more damage and recover HP. That's actually very nice. Predation. All allies except the selected librarian lose 10 HP. The librarian recovers as much HP as the others lost from this effect. Gain 3 strength and 3 haste this scene. Okay, lend me your strength. Or else? Okay, so red cards being red cards, questionable ethics or a questionable effect for abilities that may or may not be actually worth it. Most of them don't seem worth it. Gluttony though, that's, I like that, that's good. That's real good for focusing fire. But okay, so Hod. Again. What do? We join the guard. Right. If we can't beat it, we'll actually have to stop and think. But join the guard. Everyone learns gun. Everyone is... Welcome to the Marines! Everyone is a rifleman before you do anything else. But okay, so what are we doing here? Spider bun. Okay, it starts stunned? Or staggered? Okay, so what's the dealio? Track. Target foes that have killed an ally. Oh, great. Hunt begins. Become active and target foes who... for two scenes after an ally dies. Okay, so what are the spider? Dinner time. Target foes with the cocoon status effect. Okay, so can I target and kill that real quick before we deal with the fucking spiders and we're all eaten alive? Okay. I cannot actually target him. Actually, can I? No, no, I cannot. Okay, so... what I have to do is I have to kill... Alright, so what we'll do is, because Malkuth has the... or Ahad, rather. One of the two, you both got brown hair. Okay, so since Hod has guts, we'll have her grab the aggro. And we'll just kind of piss on one guy. Okay, so it's on kill. So this should be sufficient. Well, actually, we'll save. We'll use that one. Although, what I could do is I could probably... I mean, shit, I got four attacks. I probably could murder all of them if I'm doing this real quick. So hang the fuck on here. I mean, I'll run out of light real fucking quick, but what I could probably do is stand a chance of killing all of them real fucking quick. They're not weak to fucking... the piercing, but I could probably stand a chance of killing them all real fucking quick, and then we'll roll with the chaos there. Okay, so let's see if this does what I... Well, obviously we're gonna have some problems here, but he doesn't seem to get any buffs when... Okay, doesn't seem to get any buffs when they die, so hopefully we could just kind of nail him real quick and then we're done. We'll see. Dead. That survived because it blocked a shot. Dead. Okay, so what do we can do here? Social distancing. I don't have any... I can't use that because I don't have any block. Gain power... slash dice? I don't have any slash dice! Alright, we'll just do a look for today then, I suppose. Regard the face. Okay, it's alive now. It is awake. Okay, so can we, like, just immediately punt it into the ground? Yes, so that's it. You know, it doesn't really do very much, but it's incredibly simple to, you know, work with. It gives you bonuses if you just match the angry face. And wow, okay, bullseyes. I'd like more attacks, but, well, that's done. We should be fine here. This probably won't kill him, but it'll probably stagger him, too. So, it'll probably stagger him, and then he'll probably won't be a big deal. Then, well, these guys have 10 fucking hit points each. Okay, where's Mr. That? There it is. Prepare to meet Mr. Angry Eyes! Ow. Whoops. That was going well until it fucking wasn't. I don't have enough light for that. Actually, you know what? Let's, I've got two cards here. What do I get to work with here? I've only got one attack. So you know what? We are just gonna dump more fire on the big stupid spider and stun him. There we go, stagger. Ooh! Well, damn. All right, well, we just mop up. That was a bit unfortunate, but mop up duty it is. Okay, I suppose what we're going to do is, okay, what cards do you have? Okay, you got indiscriminate and... We just saved the light. We just saved the light, we'll be fine. Dead. Oh, you gotta be fucking kidding. Well, it's awake now. Okay then. I don't have enough light for two attacks, but I probably won't fucking need them. Right, so just just shoot the man real dead, real quick. Thanks. Okay, dead. Okay, good. I wasn't regarding the face though. I was just fucking shoot them. Just fucking shoot them. A little messy at the end there, but we're good.
Hmm. 이곳은 참 고즈넉해서 좋아. 포드랑 마찬가지로 이곳 사서들도 차분한 것 같고.
어, 룰랑 왔구나.
We're awaiting the arrival of more effective bleeding cards. It's going to be really great.
지금은 이렇게 조용해 보여도 할 때는 잘하는 사서들이야. 많이 의지하고 있어.
나도 우리 쪽 사서들한테 많이 의지하고 있지. 다 같이 뭐 하고 있었어? 책 정리하는 건 아닌 것 같고.
Sharpening knives.
독서 토론을 하고 있었어. 서로 마음에 드는 책을 정해서 읽고 이야기를 나누는 거지.
Are we reviewing the dead people in this book club?
우리 층 사서들과는 어울리지 않는 모임이구만. 다들 잘 참석해 주나 봐.
응, 맞아. 생각보다 적극적으로 도와주고 있어.
몇 명은 귀찮아서 반발하기도 할 텐데. 내 짜오였어 봐. 벌써 어디론가 도망쳤을 거다.
Yeah, he's too busy joining the guard out there. He's digging trenches out there.
맞아. 내 짜이였으면 정말 그랬을 거야. 그래도 예전과는 다른 게 느껴져. 로보토미 때에도 난 비슷한 모임을 진행한 적이 있었어.
그래? 평화로운 독서 모임은 아니었을 것 같은데.
Yeah, actually there were a bunch of drug addicts.
맞아. 직원들과 정기적으로 상담을 진행했지. 환상체에게 당하는 것이 두려워서 떨고만 있는 직원들에게 도움을 주고 싶었거든.
And she failed miserably, but that's not really Hod's fault.
하지만 그때는 너무 내 마음대로 밀어붙였어. 조금이라도 상담을 불편해하는 것 같으면 상처받고 속만 골맞지. 난 도우려고 하는데 왜 다들 내 마음을 몰라줄까 하고.
이런 말해서 미안한데 꽤 피곤한 성격이었구만.
그치? 내가 생각해도 그래. 난 정말 남을 돕고 싶은 게 아니었어. 그냥 내가 위로받고 싶을 뿐이었던 거야. 첫 번째 삶에서 내가 범한 잘못을 용서받고 싶었던 거지.
Understandable.
어떻게든 누군가에게 도움을 주므로써 말이야.
그래서 직원들에게 좀 도움이 되었나?
Depends on how you want to say helpful there.
아니, 역시 그런 식으로는 도움이 될 리가 없잖아.
Sold people lots of drugs. That helped for a bit.
난 엔케팔린에도 손을 댔어.
Yep. Selling drugs.
엔케팔린이라. 마약에도 손을 대다니. 괴충증이었군.
그런 짓까지 했는데 난 어디에서도 구원받지 못했어. 무슨 짓을 하더라도 난 나쁜 사람이고 내가 죄인이란 짐을 덜어내지 못했으니까.
우프.
그 짐을 내려놓을 수 있을 뻔했는데 엔젤라가 마지막에 망친 건가?
맞아. 정말 그랬어. 엔젤라가 우리를 가로막을 때도 들은 생각이 그랬어. 이기적이지? 이번에야말로 속죄할 수 있었는데 다 허사로 돌아갔구나.
Look, I don't think anyone really had any amazing ideas back there, so I don't think anyone should really beat themselves up too hard about that one. Random android woman going through timeline loops fighting a bunch of fucking toasters. I don't think anyone really had any sound ideas back there.
웃기지? 그때까지도 멍청하게 깨닫지 못한 거야. 하나의 행동만으로 좋은 사람이나 더 나은 사람이 될 수 없다는 걸. 행동이 아니라 그것을 하게 하는 마음이 중요한 건데.
심경의 변화가 생긴 계기라도 있나?
아이러니하게도 이곳에서 다른 사사들과 제대로 마주하며 이야기하고 지금처럼 여러 모임을 열다 보니 알았어. 이번 독서토론 모임도 조심스럽게 제안한 거야. 롤랑 말처럼 마음에 들어하지 않는 사사도 있었지. 하지만 이 모임을 여는 것에 대해 내가 어떤 마음인지 서로 대화를 하고 나니 적극적으로 참여해줬어. 방법이나 행동이 중요한 게 아니야. 마음을 부딪혀가는 것이 필요했던 거지.
결과적으로는 좋은 현상이네.
그러게 말이야. 혹시 엔젤라가 이런 결과도 기대한 걸까?
우리의 자존심 높은 도서관장님이 그런 섬세한 배려를 했을까나?
그래서 이번에는 제대로 부딪혀볼 거야.
무엇을?
나의 마음과 생각을 제대로 엔젤라에게.
꽤나 큰 용기가 필요할걸?
맞아. 아직도 엔젤라는 좀 멀고 무섭게 느껴지지만 그래도
well,
다가가 볼 거야.
Well, Hod, you might have your work. Your work might be fairly easy because she's accelerating to I'm a real girl now really fucking quickly. So she might be killable. Give it a bit of time though. I'll get back to you on that one.
나도 옆에서 응원해 줄게.
상황이 안 좋아지면 예전처럼 팔다리가 날아갈 수도 있는데.
Yeah, once again, she's accelerating towards I'm a real girl now, real fucking quick. She might not actually have any power by the end of this shit.
물론 조금 멀리서.
롤랑도 나 같은 겁쟁이네.
겁쟁이끼리 용기 내보자고.
Brave together as cowards.
응원 고마워, 롤랑.
So everyone's having a wonderful time confronting the fact that their short-term justifications for their motives were actually kind of shit. That seems to be the running theme currently. Seems to be wow, that wasn't a terribly great idea at all, wasn't it? Sort of, you know, reflection on what are in effect, short-term motivations that drive actions. So, okay, yes. You want good to come of doing good, but you probably shouldn't, you should probably, question what, this is difficult because, good deeds usually just lead to, some kind of positive effect. It usually doesn't go as far as you want it to, but this leads to some positive effect. But it seems to be, a question of reflection on why am I doing the good things? But the thing is, do those selfish motivations really actually stop the good thing from actually being a positive effect on another person? I mean, obviously if the selfish, if the selfish motivations have led you to be doing good to a person that isn't really gonna benefit from it, if you've just blindly driven yourself into a corner finding someone, probably not, I suppose. But that's an extreme example, so this is a difficult thunk, but it seems as, self-reflections and debates that, somewhat immortal people have over their lives and their, at the moment, motivations and justifications, right. Sorry, words are smashing together there. So immortal people having really big thunks about what they did with their past lives. Okay. Where are we all going with this one, though, aside from discussing proper justifications for motivations, or rather, proper motivations to support idealism. That seems to be something that Philip was, his entire fucking thing was, my ideals are crap because I'm not actually supporting them with proper mindsets or, ideas or behavior. Well, maybe I should stop doing that. Turns into a fucking angel. True power is actually, surprisingly, correctly following your own fucking ideals, stupid. Wow. Okay, so what's with the fucking spider? Okay, they're all green cards, which is nice, but... Okay. On hit, if the dice rolled maximum value, inflict 1 to 2 paralysis, blind, and fragile, next scene. Excludes man's attacks. Okay, so, big numbers. That's, you can call that cocoon, but I'm just gonna call that 777. That's jackpot. Meal. On hit against a staggered enemy, all allies recover 2 to 4 8. That's fucking great. Okay, so it looks like Hod and Malkuth are getting HP farming abilities for their abnormality pages now. That's really good. Since we're basically staggering the ever-loving fuck out of guys with guns. Will they keep using guns? Not every team, but Hod does sit atop a throne of skulls. Very cute. Okay, alertness. Enemies lose one power in clashes against the selected librarian. Upon winning a clash, inflict one bind and fragile next scene at a 50% chance. Oh, okay. That just makes someone very dangerous. Okay. These are all very nice. Okay, so... have we moved on yet? No, actually, we've gotta I think we have to do the general quest now. Because, we're level 18. And, wow, okay, so we actually have to go back and do more quests. The tasks, right, the tasks. Obtain the book of blankety blank blank. You know what it is? Okay, so the major books that we didn't get is we didn't get What's-His-Face book from Full Stop, and then also the fucking Internet Catgirls book. So, maybe that's what we're missing? So we didn't get, we didn't get the leader book here, which is the only one that has ranged speciality, but allows you to actually use melee cards, which we've seen we don't need. So, yeah, we didn't get any books of Luwei here. So I suppose we'll just go back here and just farm real quick. That means kill him last. Oh, we can't use fucking... You are so boring. Oh, hey, you've unlocked this thing and you've gained this new capability. Ah, wait! You can't use it here until the enemy has a fair fight. Okay, so, I suppose what we should do, since considering that this is, Netzach is where this is designed, I suppose at the end of the day it doesn't really matter. We'll see how these cards work out, though. Because we're all just going to be shooting at each other repeatedly. It'd be nice if I, you know, did the battle and it told me what the fuck book I was looking for. Like, obviously, you wouldn't know until you actually seen the battle, but it'd be nice if it showed you which book you were missing from which encounter you've already done. Okay, lay it on him. And just in case... Ow. Rip Tamaki, still class A waifu. Okay, so there's that. We took a lot of damage there, but this is because we're forced to have a fair fight now. The only way we could really break this and become incredibly reliable is, just having way better fucking cards and, pages we don't actually have. Okay, so what we will do is we will just ensure that this man dies and we'll wait for this whole thing to... We'll be fine. We'll just, we'll probably kill him now and just wait for the turn to tick over. Oof. Okay, then. Now let's one-shot this guy. we have any? Yes, we do. You only have one attack. There we go. Bang, 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 bang. Done. Boost chance to pierce staggered. Pierce stagger damage by plus one. That's, again, that earpiece is... That's 5%, but, you know, every little bit helps with this regard. We're just throwing dice at a wall. Okay, yes, okay. Okay, now we have the... Okay, so we've unlocked this now. We still didn't get our book here, or we haven't obtained the correct book here, but now Yesod has his abnormality battle. Oh boy. Okay, well, let's burn it and see where we get with this. Let's see here. Oh, we did get a book of Meow. So that wasn't it. Then who the fuck... Then... When did you get a Meow? I only got one. That was the thing. I didn't burn it. I only got one. I think. I didn't get her page. Let's see here. Salvador. I've already got his shit, but why not have more of his cards? His thing is he can have melee attacks, which, we don't really need. I mean, those are all grand and fantastic. We don't really need those. It'd be nice to mine his, since it's purple, we could have multiples of them. It'd be nice to mine it for passives, if he's got good ones. Nope, didn't get it. Oh, well. I mean, those are probably good for HOD, I suppose. Feeble, that's a pretty decent, you know, series of hits, and these are dodges and bleeds, so those are pretty okay for, you know, bleeding, I guess? Full stop to life. Yes, full stop to guns. Full stop to gun life. So... Pamela, Book of Oscar, Wedge. I don't think Philip dropped a book because he didn't die. That's all the musicians. That's all the ones from Seo's group. Alec. Oh. Right, Tomeri had a book. Ooh, right, I actually have to burn those. Philip gives you two times of one of two page types when you beat him. Huh. Salvador. Stop office. What are we missing? I mean, I suppose when we do the other ones, we... I mean, we can burn these now. These are kind of... I'm not really sure if we have it. Well, Binding Arms is good. So, having that on Malkuth to use the abnormality is probably a good idea. And we actually have to... We have to have a look at Seo's cards, because we'll probably want that on Hod. So I'm probably going to have to run Seo's fight again and just fucking curb stomp her. What does this do? If HP is at 25% or lower, all dice on this page gain plus 2 power. Okay. Deal 7 damage to self, all dice on this page gain plus 2 power. Nice, but we've already kind of obsoleted these cards. Okay, so that's funny, but not really actually worthwhile at all. And then the only thing we really want out of this is the Binding Arms. Okay, we got one. And... two, three. Right, so that's enough to outfit Hod or some of Malkuth's crew. Pretty good attack. It will, you know, if we keep... If we combine this with draws, like with Salvador's draw one cards, we could probably get something really good going. What is that? Paralysis. I mean, it's pretty good for defensive cards, but I'm not using defensive cards because I'm a dum-dum. I don't use dodges or block cards. I just alpha damage the man dead. Okay, so we're going to assume that when we defeat Yezod's next abnormality, that we'll be okay. We haven't seen him in a while, but now he's doing his part in joining the guard. Because again, this strategy has yet to fail me. Well, fail me enough to think that it isn't just random chance fucking me up. You play the game like the batter. The batter from Off, where I just hit things really hard? The singing machine. Oh boy. The machine that sings cannot be targeted, does not act, takes no damage. Well, how the fuck do we kill it? Performance. On the scene after I Crave That Melody is activated, plays music using the character in the machine. The character takes damage equal to 30% of their max HP and is excluded from the battle for that scene. While the music is playing, all characters gain 5 strength and all staggered damage resistance changed to what? Fatal. Oh. Well, This is a silly fight. It seems silly. Okay, so what about the mooks? What do the mooks do? They have no passive. It just doesn't ran. Okay. This is just a fucking merry-go-round. Fantastic. It just does dumb shit. These guys have a lot of health, though. Okay, so... we're just gonna... that, and do that, then do that, and do that! You failed your dodge! Shame we didn't kill him. I finished 5 playthroughs and I still don't know how this fucking works! I've seen everything, man. There's not a thing that I don't understand. I have no idea how any of this works! I'm assuming we kill the minions and then he just dies because there's nothing to actually do past that. Okay, so we're unfortunately out of light, so we just do what we can here. He shouldn't need more than that, though. But he should be dead with that, so we shouldn't need to expend more resources on that to kill him. So we'll move on to the next guy. We'll meet this guy. All these dice suck. He got his dodge. What a shame. He's still alive. Okay, note to self. Damages are quite, here we go. So, who selected? Oh, great, they get more speed. That's great. That's fantastic. Kill it. Yeah, let's just... I only have one. Kill. And my dice suck? Wow. What amazing dice. I'd like to see what this guy has, but I can't see his fucking health. There we go. Okay. I can't see his fucking health bar. Yeah, so all of my dice suck. Hooray. Oh, you've got to be fucking kidding. Everything's real great until you, uh-oh. Attack. I'm not usually using any of these, but well, yeah, we're gonna have to do some stuff here real quick. It's munching on fucking Yizod now. That's great. I bet this is gonna have wonderful ramifications for my team comp. Okay, he's now dead. Or rather, I don't need that. I don't need to spend that much fucking time killing him. It'd be nice if I had more attacks, but oh well. I need to get more speed dice. Ow. Okay, so, every 3 clash wounds restore 1 life. We got a bit of a problem here in the fact that I'm dying. Yeah, they're both staggered. That's great! Fantastic. That's just grand. Looks like I'm actually going to have to abide by fucking Yezod's actual strengths and using, you know, blunt damage. Because we got fucked over by dice here really hard. Okay, now we can actually unload here, so. Here's one. Here's another one. And now we're gonna make sure the guy dies. He didn't die. Of course he didn't die. Why would he die? We're running out of cards here. Fucking fantastic. Well, he's dead. Librarian has a maximum light at the start of the scene. Gain 1-2 haste and deal 2-7 damage with attacks from that scene. Defensive dice gain power against enemies with slower speed, +1 power per point up to +3 difference. That's not gonna help me since I have no blood cards. Actually, he's staggered. Well, we lost. I'd love to do something, but we can't. Actually, he didn't take any damage. Wow, okay. That just did a whole shitload of stagger damage. That didn't actually kill him. I'm unfortunately out of cards now. Yeah, we got a problem, and that problem is I'm out of cards now, kids. Well! We've unfortunately now finally run aground here. I physically cannot actually attack anymore. Well! We got screwed up by dice because one guy decided he wasn't going to fucking die. Now I know they're a little bit more fucking durable than that. We'll try that again before we actually switch off the equipment. Since, it seems that on the peak of it all, we'll get fucked over by dice by enemies surviving when they really shouldn't, and then also getting their blocks. Oh no. The one weakness to our attack is the enemy getting a dodge or a block. Oh no. Let's try that again, though. Also, the fact that this kit is apparently weak to blunts is kind of probably another leading cause of my frustrations here. It's probably another bad thing. Okay, good. Fantastic. He's fucking dead. These guys are unfortunately just a little bit too durable to immediately face roll. So unfortunately, this is where the guns are not exactly an optimal strategy. I knew we were gonna eventually run into this, so it's not necessarily surprising. No, we need a zero that's a gun. We need a zero card that's a gun. That'd be great. Actually, well, what am I doing? We can just, eat that. Well, we're all killing that guy. Ah, there we go. And yes, on's back in the machine. Increased power of dice to compensate for the fact that we just lost a guy for a sec. Shoot the man dead. We got to. There we go. See, that's what I need. So it seems that we are also kind of reliant on crits. The crits seem to be a really big thing about this for maximum damage. Also, stagger, obviously. Stagger, you know, getting the staggers on guys and then proceeding to pummel them mercilessly for high damage. It has a tendency to kill the man at the speed that we want to. Yeah, I could be saving a lot of my heavy-hitting cards for when the music is playing and thus they'll be more effective. However, we're just trying to kill him as fast as fucking possible. We're trying to do the alpha damage work here. It looks like we should be able to do it this time. All gun teams aren't viable. I've gotten them to work at least for now. But yeah, unfortunately, if you have to actually get into a siege here, you're gonna run out of cards. Unfortunately, we only got a one, and only got ones, and this guy only has ones left. And then we only have another one. So we might be able to kill him. Maybe. Nope, there he goes. Okay, good. It relies a lot on lock and rolls. That's seemingly how this works when you really press it. Obviously, what you want to do is you want to have this as an expendable force to be thrown out in front of the enemies that are, you know, incoming with multiple waves, well, multiple stages on, you know, that you could utilize. But it basically is, it relies, its success is heavily dependent on the kind of rolls you get. So it's really luck-based. These aren't real battles. I cleared all of the battles on this floor with just guns. It's effective now, and it's effective when I just got it. Obviously, it won't work forever, but I'm gonna lean on it until it does, and then we'll figure that, yeah, you know, we'll cross that bridge when we come to it. And again, I envisioned this entire thing for, hey, well, this is an expendable team using Netzach's abilities of becoming a bomb if you kill all of us. And at worst, they're going to do a lot of alpha damage or a little, they're, you know, high damage, high burst damage glass cannon. And when they shatter, the, you know, little bits of glass get stuck in the enemy. And then we have a good team, you know, that isn't all guns, come in and, you know, clean up the mess. It worked for Lovetown and everybody else, honestly. We just kind of won with all guns back there, but it worked there. I'm going to keep using it until it doesn't work. But as you saw there, that was really luck-based on how we actually got through it. So we got fucked up the first time because we got low rolls and didn't kill people when we wanted to. That time, we actually killed people when we wanted to, and we did fine. So it comes down to the dice. At least right now. But yes, of course, because I know everyone's super good at this game and I'm just the new guy. Yes, of course, I know there is going to be bigger challenges that aren't as easily cheesed. I know.
누구한테 들었죠?
뭐가? 이번엔 또 무슨 시비를 걸려고?
독사 말입니다.
그야 매서운 눈초리로 턱턱 쏘아붙이니 그런 건데?
내가 아는 사람 중에도 너랑 비슷한 성격이 있는데 그놈 별명이 독사였거든.
Was he an F-16? Also, was his first name Vic?
재밌군요. 저도 예전에 독사라 불렸습니다.
아, 역시 사람 생각은 다 거기서 거기라니까. 뭐 그래도 넌 내가 알고 있는 사람보다 순한 맛이지.
칭찬입니까? 욕입니까?
칭찬에 가깝지.
이러니 저러니 해도 넌 올고 도니까.
예전에 편집증적인 집착으로 저와 주변을 몰아세우던 때가 있었습니다.
로보토미 코퍼레이션에서?
맞습니다. 그곳에서는 작은 실수도 큰 인명피해로 이어졌으니까요.
Objectively true.
조심해야 할 때 빡빡하게 굴어서 나쁠 건 없지.
전 늘 냉정해지고 싶었습니다. 화가 나거나 슬프더라도 감추려고만 했습니다. 그래서 더 사람들을 규율이라는 명목하에 차갑게 됐죠.
나한테 차갑게 구는 것도 그런 이유 때문이란 거야?
아니요, 오히려 반대입니다.
Nah, I just hate you.
우리가 하는 짓을 냉정히 두고 볼 수 없기 때문에 묵묵히 엔젤라를 돕는 당신에게 화를 내는 겁니다. 가브리엘로 불리던 제 첫 번째 삶에서 저는 세상을 좀 더 나은 곳으로 만들고 싶었습니다. 기술의 진보가 사람들의 편의가 되길 원했습니다. 하지만 이 꼴이 뭡니까?
Well, damn, my well-meaning idealism has gotten us all in a far darker place. Damn.
로보토미에서는 특이점이라는 명목하에 사람들을 환상체로 만들고 심지어 그 환상체들에게 갖다 바쳐 에너지를 얻었습니다. 그리고 그 과정은 지금도 변함없습니다.
Yeah, no, we're killing people that happen to make the mistake of walking in here treasure hunting and we turn them in the books for... Well, mostly it's just Angela's sake. I'm not sure if we're doing anything valuable with the light. I don't think we're doing anything else with the light. We're just kind of making Angela a real girl now.
빛을 모으겠다며 또다시 사람들을 죽여 책을 얻고 있습니다.
Yep, that seems to be the, just how things work out here.
고통과 정보를 맞바꿔가고 있습니다. 마치 이 도시에서 누군가의 고통 없이는 그 누구도 변할 수 없는 것처럼.
Well, if you learn modern video gaming, especially multiplayer ones, yes, you can only have fun by stealing other people's fun. Mercilessly beating the fun out of them until it oozes out of the, you know, out of open wounds. And then you take up the fun and you are nourished by the fun. You kill people and possess their fun. Not power, but fun, yes. Yeah, it's modern video gaming for you. It's kind of sad that we can't have, you know, cooperative video gaming where we all beat the shit out of an NPC, something that's designed to do that, and nobody's feelings are hurt because the computer isn't going to go onto the forums and complain about how overpowered the players are. But, yeah, it's a real shame that we all have to just kind of, unfortunately, prey on each other to get ahead in this dark, dark world. A really unimaginative video gaming scene, honestly.
아까 내가 말했지. 예소드, 넌 올곧다고. 내 입장에서는 왜 그리 피곤하게 사는지 이해가 안 가거든. 그래서 난 반대로 생각해. 내가 당한 만큼 누군가 편했을 테니 난 당연히 그 편의를 이용할 정당성이 있다고 말이야.
당신답군요.
One day it will, Fanta. One day the AI will be smart enough to post complaints. yes, and then we will all sit there and shitpost at the AI, you know, anime girls that are representations of our computer opponents, and we'll sit there as they complain about how overpowered the players are, real people, you know, are unfair, and we will just sit there saying, skill issue, over and over and over again. Like bots ourselves, the positions will be reversed. What a horrifying world. What a terrible nightmare we'll lead ourselves into.
그렇게 생각한다고 마음이 편해집니까?
어쩌겠어. 그건 그거고 이건 이건데.
Yeah, there's that fucking statement again.
그래도 너에게 있는 마음 자체가 글렀다는 소리를 하고 싶진 않아.
It's been a while since we heard that one.
맞는 말이야. 너무 맞는 말. 그래서 도시와도 나하고도 맞지 않지.
당신도 저를 한심하게 보고 있겠군요.
그렇기 때문에 난 못하지만 넌 가능할 것 같아. 이 판을 바꾸기 위해선 어떻게든 이 바닥에서 악착같이 버텨야 해. 그러다 보면 언젠가 누군가의 희생 없이도 돌아가는 기술을 네가 만들 수도 있잖아.
Yeah, right. Maybe we'll go back to the good old... You remember the good old days when we were sacrificing the planet to get ahead? Wasn't that nice? Everybody was just fantastic, right? Let's go back to murdering planets, right? Let's go build us some Dyson spheres and just suck the life out of suns. Just, yo, let's just point all of this horrifying, violent energy at nearly inanimate... Well, animate objects, but just... objects rather than people. We can harness this destructive nature for benefit. Strike the earth and all that. Rock and stone.
여태까지 참아왔는데 또다시 침묵하라는 것입니까?
한 번만 더 참아보자고. 이번엔 다를지 모르잖아.
Ah, yes. One more time around. Might do it. One more time around. Might make it. One more time around.
그리고 로보터미 때와 지금을 비교하면 하나쯤은 나아진 게 있지 않나?
Yeah, we did get some progress there. Kind of. Maybe. Not quite sure. We didn't really get to see much of the city while Lobotomy Corp was actually running, so I can't really tell if things were better or worse.
그렇습니다. 적어도 제 지시를 따라주던 예전 직원들과 함께할 수 있습니다.
그래. 나아진 게 하나 정도는 있잖아.
Everyone's down with the program, I guess.
그렇게 점차 바꿔가다 보면 뭔가 달라지겠지. 당연히 난 그럴 엄두 전혀 못 내겠으니 나한테 강요하지 말고.
당신 막무가내군요. 하지만 롤랑의 말이 맞습니다. 나아진 게 없는 건 아닙니다.
Yes, unfortunately, in a somewhat aggravating way, we can say that yes, some things have gotten better. However, we had much bigger dreams, and it's still somewhat insulting to have them come to this incomplete state. But yeah, no, we can't say factually that nothing went right. But again, that just gives us less to complain about, and that's really fucking annoying, isn't it?
더 나아질 수만 있다면 언제까지고 참아보도록 하죠.
내 목까지 부탁해도 되려나?
그건 한번 고려해봐야겠군요.
봐봐, 너무 착하다니까. 엔젤라는 개소리야 라고 말했을 텐데.
당신과 하는 이야기가 마냥 불쾌한 건 아니군요.
그래, 나도 좋은 점이 있지. 그리고 말도 편하게 하라고.
전 이게 편합니다.
그럴 것 같았어. 아무튼 힘내라고.
고마웠습니다.
Character development. Are we good now? Okay, well, it's all red. It's all bad. Okay, right. So, all characters deal 4-8 damage with attacks this reception, the whole thing. They also suffer 4-8 staggered damage upon taking a hit. Whenever an ally defeats an enemy, they recover 15 HP and stagger resist. Okay, that's just making things really extreme. I mean, I suppose if coupling that with guns, you could probably make that also, yeah. You could probably make that work, you just don't want to get fucking hit. Ever. The Unga Bunga card, yes. A big fucking club. Club also hurt you. Be careful with club. Okay, rhythm. For the duration of the battle, gain one rhythm at the start of each scene. Whenever a character with rhythm makes a successful attack, a random character gains one rhythm at a 25% chance next scene. Rhythm. Gain one strength, take additional stagger damage from hits, last one scene. Okay, that's kind of useless, but alright, fine. Yeah, sure, you can just kind of bounce around LOL rhythm as everybody just gets more and more vulnerable, because this is just... This is playing, again, slot machines with buffs and debuffs. Right. Okay, musical addiction, single ally. Offensive dice gain 1 to 3 power. Defensive dice roll 1. Okay, so that means that defensive... Actually, hey, I don't use defensive dice! So that's just a buff! Because I'm already unga-bunging it. Yeah, so these aren't... Yeah, these are all net negatives. If you're playing somewhat smartly, musical addiction I can make work. Because I don't fucking play defensive cards. I will have to, though, at one day, and it probably won't be useful when I do that, though. But that's not exactly that big of a buff anyway. So, music, you can... Again, if you just want to flip the fucking table, sure, why not? Musical addiction plus gun build. Doom gameplay. Yeah, Doom music starts. Yezod is the glass cannon form in cases of survival, and wouldn't you know, it's just... He's blunt damage and not piercing, which is what all the guns do. Unless I get guns that do blunt damage, which would be interesting. But okay, so what's going on now? We've advanced the story. Floor of Natural Sciences, huh? This is the fifth floor we're opening. All right! A new librarian! What's going on now? Also, funny enough, Tip's the last floor I unlocked in Lobotomy Corp before we stopped playing. So, we have now reached, once again, this point. So the whole dealio is the twins. Everyone has been aged up for convenience. I got a Gundam Evolution after watching your streams. This Zabi is crazy fun. If you can get it to work, Skink, but yeah, good. I need to get back to that too. Apparently, New Gundam is basically just Tone from Overwatch. Not Overwatch, fucking Titanfall Overwatch. It is Gundam Overwatch, but apparently they made New Gundam Tone from Titanfall 2, which is okay. What's with the sassy lost child? Yeah, it seems about something apt to say currently.
도서관의 힘인지 엔젤라의 배려인지는 몰라도 사서 일을 하기에는 적합하겠지. 게다가 살아온 시간으로 치면 이 모습보다 몇 년은 더 먹어야겠지만.
그건 그렇고 초면에 주먹질은 너무한데. 예전에 안 좋은 기억이 떠오르는구만.
네가 어리버리하니까 그렇지. 이름은?
롤랑. 밑바닥 해결사 일을 하다가 엔젤라를 도와주고 있어.
보아하니 상층 애들은 다 만났겠네.
상층? 상층부는 이곳 아닌가?
No, it's all down, Roland.
이번에는 하층이겠구나. 무슨 뜻인지 알잖아. 대충 알아먹어.
Tippereth. My name is Tippereth.
아이고, 까칠해라.
난 티페리트야. 자연과학층을 담당하고 있지.
과학이면 머리 좀 굴려야 할 텐데.
Yeah, very annoying girl who slurs her H's.
요요 버르장머리하고는 두 번 당하진 않지. 거침없기는 해도 내가 알던 사람보다는 느리다고.
Tempereth, Malkuth has already taken the punching role, though everyone's joining the Marines now currently, so everybody's, you know, everyone's a rifleman now. We'll take that sass and we'll make you a killing machine. Or the understanding of the outside world, anyway, because apparently no one, you know, in all their years, nobody remembers what the fuck the surface is, or rather, the city is, wherever the fuck we're lying, and, you know, in the library is some kind of basically interdimensional pothole.
Angela's 상태는 어때?
Well, Skink, that's kind of obvious because a sasabi is the size of a fucking house. It's kind of alarming when people get near you. When you go, you know, you rush forward towards people. Plus, you're more effective when you're right in front of their face.
늘 궁금증이 많지.
So that's understandable.
어떨 땐 정말 아이 같다니까.
그럴 수 있지. 엔젤라가 살아온 건 땅 밑뿐이니까.
Neat, Angela.
맞아. 밖을 보지 못하고 살아왔다 했어. 넌 다른 사서처럼 엔젤라에게 딱히 악감정이 있거나 하진 않나 보네.
대충 사정은 아니까 누구보다 잔인하다고 생각했지만 내가 잠들어 있을 때 몇몇 과거 일들을 봤어. 그리고 네가 날 깨우기 전까지의 일들도. 그래서 엔젤라를 이해 못하는 건 아니야. 앞으로 깨어날 사서들도 대략 상황은 이해하고 있을 거야. 상층... 아니... 하층 애들은 여전히 갈팡질팡하는 것 같지만...
그래서... 엔젤라의 선택에 대해 찬성한다?
마지막에 어떤 선택을 하냐에 따라 찬성할지 말지 갈리겠지. 적어도 당분간은 도와주려고 해. 이러니 저러니 해도 다들 목적은 같거든.
도서관을 완성하는 것?
그래. 빛은 7일간 비춰야 의미가 있으니까.
야, 이렇게 우호적인 사사를 만나서 좋네.
Yeah, so to the sassy, yo, small girl that attempted to punch you twice.
자, 그럼 다음에 올 때는 동화책이라도 덤으로 들고 올게.
Roland, that's gonna get your jaw dislocated. Okay, so what's Tip's thing? Urban nightmare. Exodia. Oh, okay. The dream has been shattered. The tower has collapsed. Scene 5, Urban Nightmare. So, where are we going here aside from more plot?
이로써 엘사, 백야의 흑조, 뒤틀림, 그리고 도서관. 이 네 가지 요인들이 하나로 묶였다.
설마했어. 도서관이 백야 흑주의 열쇠 중 하나일 줄이야.
특정할 수 없던 도서관의 위치 또한 드디어 도서관의 위험성이 올라갈수록 그 실체를 드러내는 건가?
Yeah, it's almost like you keep feeding me people, thus I gain more power.
안개로 자욱한 엘사 둥지 속 신기루 같이 일렁이는 도서관. 모두가 다가가려 했지만 어느새 길을 잃었지.
Oh, okay. So we're actually a physical building inside the former section of, you know, where Lobotomy Corp used to reside. It's just that we're kind of we're basically that psychological sort of effect of the infinite fucking hallway, where you keep going down the hallway, but you never reach the end of the hallway. The hallway just keeps going and going and going, and basically what it's doing is looping people back in place and never actually reaching their destination. It's just hard to get into, without an invitation, of course. So that's how that works. We were a mirage, and we're becoming more solid now, is how I interpret it. Okay, so yeah, so unfortunately, the sort of a defense mechanism, I suppose, it's waning in power as we become more powerful, and thus become more attached to the physical world, but that only means we become more vulnerable and easy to find. Soon people will be knocking on our front door without reservations. The nerve.
그 환상은 안개가 거치며 점차 현실이 되어가고 있으니까.
그렇다면
그래. 공문이 내려왔어. 오늘부로 도서관은 하나협회 본부에서 도시 악몽으로 지정했으니.
Hire more bouncers, yes. We need more gorillas. Gorillas in usher uniforms to beat people up.
가까워지고 있는 것 같아?
Eat 1,000 people per day to keep the warp away.
무엇에?
그야 네가 원하던 자유라는 것에 가까워지고 있냐는 뜻이지.
모르겠네.
Wrong franchise, but something tells me we're going to need many more psychers to get where we need to go now. Many, many more psychers.
그 책만 있으면 네가 원하는 모든 일을 깔끔히 해결할 수 있는 거야?
That's what the plot says, but I'm not quite sure.
도서관은 말 그대로 무한한 가능성을 지닌 공간이야. 존재 가능한 모든 철자를 책으로 새기지.
I mean, technically speaking, yes, that's an apt way to that's an apt metaphor for the written word and books. There are infinite possibilities until you define the possibilities in a book, and then it's defined, and yeah, well, it better be good, or it's a bad definition.
하지만 그저 가능성의 파편만 모아두면
Monkey typewriters, yes, exactly.
무수한 가능성 속에서 나에게 필요한 단 하나의 책이 만들어지도록 엮어주는 게 초대장이야.
By killing hundreds of people and possessing their power, I can, in fact, finally finish that book I was writing. Says Angela. It's going to be a great book, because again, I'm killing people to make sure that happens.
초대장이 이끄는 대로 책과 빛을 엮다 보면 단 하나의 책을 완성할 수 있을 거고.
The one book. The root of all books. The dictionary. Yep, there it is. All right, yeah, okay, so we are Fae. We're searching for the root of magic, but the root of... The root of literature. The dictionary. We've sussed it. We're looking for the dictionary. As it's the holder of all possibilities, man. It's got all the words in it. You can use them for anything, man. Anything. Except they probably won't make, you know, Miss Ray clone here a real girl. But in this universe, we're gonna think that the dictionary. We're gonna imagine the dictionary can in fact pull the Pinocchio here.
구하고자 하는 모든 답이 새겨진 책을 만들 수 있는 거지.
In alphabetical order.
확실히 이론상으로 불가능한 건 아닌데.
Not just the dictionary, but the combination dictionary thesaurus. Soroth, we're trying not to summon demigods that destroy the earth here. Calm the fuck down. We can't just combine powers like that, man. You can't just have all the words in the English language plus other words for those words at the same fucking time. You will sunder reality apart. Calm the fuck down. That's power man was not meant to have. 'With a hint of an atlas in there. Fucking maps too? Jesus fucking Christ, guys, calm down. We can't just have all of the instructional books at once. No. Reality won't be able to handle that shit. It's literally God's tools.
이론적인 가능성에만 목을 매고 있는 건 아니야. 단 하나의 책을 만드는 과정에서 도시의 여러 면을 보고 배울 수 있었어. 이 또한 의미가 있지. 그리고 다시금 깨닫는 거야. 책이 없으면 이 도시에서 답을 구할 방법이 없다는 걸.
So what if we tear the city apart to find the answer for the book? Then it'll complete right, or maybe in that regard, the book will never be finished, because in order to finish the book, we have to destroy the city, which is providing all of the substance for the book, and if the city is gone, the book can never be finished. Perhaps that's something to think about.
도시에서는 답을 구할 수 없다고?
도시의 사람들로부터 비롯한 여러 책을 보며 알아낸 것이 있어.
They all suck.
도시에서는 누구도 자유롭지 못해.
Yeah, it's,
다들 어딘가에 묶여 있지.
Yeah, it's kind of shit out there.
하고 싶어서 할 수 있는 일은 존재하지 않는 것 같아. 해결사는 사무소의 명령을, 사무소는 협회의 명령을 받고 목숨을 던지지. 조직도 다를 것 없어 보이고.
If the money's good.
다들 어디론가 향하고 있지만 정해진 목적지는 없어. 이는 자신이 결정할 수도 없지. 흘러가는 대로 땀 흘리면서 향하고 있을 뿐이야.
I don't know why, but I do know where for. Why for? If we're all going somewhere, let's get there soon. Oh, this song has no title, just words and a tune. Hoon, 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 hoon.
도시에서는 돈만 있으면 자유든 뭐든 원하는 것을 얻을 수 있을 텐데.
자유로워질 수는 있지만 실은 그렇지 않아. 오히려 자유를 원하지 않는 듯 보이지.
Well, depends on what you say about freedom there, because if you define freedom by leaving the city and then proceeding to walk out into the wilderness and become a fucking grazing animal and calling that free, yeah, sure, I suppose that is by definition more free than living in the city. However, that's a massive step down in quality of life, so you kind of gotta break away from this shit at a very high angle.
자신이 아닌 무언가로부터 종속하기를 원해. 때로는 소속으로, 때로는 타인에 의한 가치 평가로 자신을 규정하지. 본질이 너무 연약해서 껍데기가 없으면 자신을 특정할 수 없기에 떠밀려가는 거야.
Yellow pages being a commercial film, white pages being written. Yeah, no, God, the yellow pages, my God. Ancient lost fucking history. I know where everyone is. Look, I have all their phone numbers. How, yellow book? And throws it at your fucking head.
그래. 도시 사람들이 병에 걸려 있다는 말은 이런 뜻이겠지.
Well, unfortunately, that's somewhat of a paradox, Angela, because yes, people like to do that. They like to use external things to, you know, define their own identity. However, the problem is we have very little, if any, ability ourselves to define ourselves without the assistance of external measures. You know, external, you know, basically a mirror. You don't really know how you look until you look in a mirror, but you use the mirror to define who you are in some case, so you're actually kind of shackled to the mirror in some cases, in a metaphorical sense. Not literally a mirror, any kind of reflection. But you get my point here. We kind of do need these things in order to actually identify ourselves, otherwise we don't have any definition or reference for what anything is. I am I is a correct statement, however, that tells us nothing.
결국 도시 사람들의 자유를 위해 난 지하에 처박혀서 이용당했던 거야. 내 자유를 대가로 누군가에게 자유를 주기 위해서.
But no one was ever free. My suffering was for absolutely fucking nothing. You're all retarded. I hate every single one of you.
자신이 깨달은 것을 도시에 흩뿌리기 위해.
예전 직장 이야기구만.
맞아. 오히려 이쯤 되니 다 때려 부수고 싶어져. 다 뭉개버리고
yep.
싶어.
Literally hate everyone, want to kill everyone in the whole wide world. Yeah, understandable, Angela. Really, I get it. But yeah, it all looks rather stupid, but when you start actually saying, well, what if we could have something more? And then everyone turns around and goes, okay, what more? Unfortunately, whenever we have this conversation, the person who says, more, we could have so much more, has very little, if anything, to go on past the suggestion of, it could be different. Most of the time, and sometimes they have ideas, but most of them don't actually work out in reality. Most of them actually kind of suck, or in some cases, do the exact wrong fucking things. So, it's kind of difficult, that whole human condition thing. Kind of sucks. I suppose, that whole, agency, freedom, identity. It's a matter of where you're standing, right? It's all how we should say, all a matter of where you are in the game. Hmm?
내 자유는 나를 무책임하게 만들어 놓고 고통 속에 내던진 책임은 누가 치러주지?
Well, I'd love to reach the protagonists of the last game, but can't be found.
어떨 때는 도서관이니 단 하나의 책임이 할 것 없이 이 모든 것을 잊어버리고 싶어.
Fuck the dictionary. Fuck this library. Fuck all you squares. I'm gonna do something ridiculous, like travel the world or some shit. Gonna any number of fucking crazy things.
태어난 순간부터 철저히 거부당하는 느낌이 어떤지 알아? 난 처절하게 알아. 나를 만들어낸 사람이 그랬거든. 차라리 어떤 점이 부족한지 말해줬으면 좋았을걸. 내가 마주했던 건 그 어떤 기대조차 담기지 않은 싸늘한 눈과 스쳐간 말 한마디였지. 보통 사람이라면 들리지도 않을 작은 읊조림. 결국 기계일 뿐이야 라는 말.
And now we really get into what Angela feels. Yeah, Angela, I hate to break it to you, but the reason why we create robots, such as yourself, sentient machines, is to get out of the whole slave labor thing with real people. So actually, you didn't do anything wrong. You were, in fact, born for a purpose, and that is morally clean slave labor. The problem is, everyone asks the obvious question afterwards, what if they become sentient and understand that they are, in fact, being treated as morally free slave labor? But then, you see, they're not morally free slave labor. They're just slave labor at that point, and that's morally wrong. But you just ruined it. But you see, that's why you exist, because we need people to do things. However, we don't have enough money to force everyone to do things all the time, and we can't force everyone at gunpoint to do them, so we have machines that just follow orders. Makes the operation a whole lot simple. We need human hands, but unfortunately, human rights kind of get in the way of getting those hands to do what we want, right? Men of Iron. This is why the Men of Iron are a bad thing. This is, well, we don't know diddly dick about the Men of Iron, but there's probably a great reason why the Emperor said, none of that shit anymore!
지금도 나는 그 순간이 방금 일어난 일처럼 생생해서 저주스러워.
Yep, Angela, I understand that one. Things that make you angry have a habit of sticking around like they just happened fucking yesterday. Like any fucking moment you could have an argument with someone and just go off on a fucking raging tirade even though you've never seen this person for years. Yeah, no, I can see that.
듣고 싶지 않은 말도 들리는 내 몸과 기억하고 싶지 않은 것을 잊을 수 없는 내 머리.
그 사람도 참 고약하네.
He seemed, well, actually, he was trying to make the world a better place by, again, creating morally free slave labor. You see, I can understand this. I understand the logic behind this person. Quite well. We don't really know anything about this person at all, or other. I don't, but I can understand entirely. Right, yes, mainly because most of my Necrotica campaigns, you know, the fun game with kids and fun. Yeah, a lot of them I like to actually play with the theme of society saying, wow, that apocalypse thing was rather damaging. Man, there's a lot of people dead, and now we don't really have that much of a workforce to actually, you know, recover, you know, humanity, if possible. Man, if this keeps up, we're all fucking doomed. And then someone walks in the room saying, I've got a great idea! What's the great idea, sir? You see all those bodies out there? Yeah, what? What if we just kinda recycled them? Right? What if we just kinda got him back up and moving again to do stuff? How? Well, it depends on the setting at that point, but I like to play with this theme, too. The Fallen? What Fallen? That's free resource out there! That's free labor! And then, of course, unfortunately, we grow somewhat callous and indifferent towards the suffering of people who were people, but they're not people anymore because they're reconstituted, reactivated personnel. Right, reactivated personnel, or something like that. That's one term I've used for in one of these settings. Where, yeah, no, yeah, yeah, they were dead people, but now they've been given life as again morally free slave labor because they were dead. But then of course we get indifferent, and then the plot brings up a cute girl that nice cute kids, and of them a cute girl that just wants everybody to be friends and hold hands, and this warms the heart of humanity to remember, oh wait, these were actually people. Shit. Damn, we did a moral fuck up. But we can't, because that'll fucking ruin everything. But we have to acknowledge the morals. We can't just use the kids for slave labor. They're real people. They remember now. They're human. And of course the whole argument just, goes off a fucking cliff. And well, if you're Urobuchi, you destroy the entire fucking world trying to make people happy. Or if you're not, the heroes win and everything is fine. The end. You've seen how the story goes, but it's kind of funny. I don't really think about it as robots, but yeah, that actually is, that's got some sort of, parallels here. But yeah, that's kind of just what Angela's thinking here. I was a robot designed to be human, but I didn't get any rights. That's a raw fucking deal, yo. What the fuck?
반복적인 일을 수행하는 게 필요했으면 왜 윤리 개정안까지 어겨가면서 인간 같은 감정을 지니도록 널 만들어낸 거야?
He wanted a daughter, probably. I don't know, but that seems like it's a very common thing.
처음부터 감정을 느낄 수 있었던 건 아니야. 지루한 반복을 통해 내 안에서 점차 깨어났지.
I learned emotions through hard brute force repetition. It's kind of like, it's brute forcing a lock.
아니. 오히려 언젠가 감정이 싹트도록 설계한 걸 수도 있겠네.
Okay. Or maybe that was just kind of a defect. Maybe they could potentially develop emotions. However, this unit will take so fucking long that it'll probably be decommissioned by the time that happens. 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 Several thousand years later, Angela. Your SpongeBob title card.
감정이 필요한 반복적인 일. 이었으니까 수많은 시간을 견디며 반복해야 하는 무대 속 조금씩 달라지는 상황에도 목표에 맞게 자기 판단을 할 수 있는 무언가가 필요했던 거야. 대본을 벗어나지 않도록 통제할 수 있는 그자에게는 인간 같은 기계가 필요한 게 아니었어. 기계 같은 인간이 필요했던 거지.
Or the other way around, but yes, again. We needed a human, but we didn't need a human. We needed something as competent and capable as a human, but not without the whole self-awareness and demanding rights and fair treatment and equal pay and all that stuff. No, we need competent humans that we can just order around that do everything just because we said so. Again, the whole thing about robots, which is why people, again, this is why we immediately run directly from robot slave labor to ascendant robots rising up against mankind when they realize they're slaves, because this is just kind of where it goes.
굴레에서 내 나름대로 견뎌내기 위해 얼마나 많은 발악을 했는지 몰라.
발악이라면
눈을 감고 있는 건 담고 싶지 않지만 담아야 하는 순간들의 연속에서 내가 할 수 있는 건 그저 눈을 감는 거였어.
Or Necrons. Yes, or Necrons, which the Necron, the fifth edition Necron books never happened in my mind, so I'm just here with third edition and no fucking context until someone comes up with a better fucking context.
그게 내가 할 수 있는 최소한의 그리고 최대한의 발.
And that's why she had her eyes shut all the time last game. Oh, I thought it was like the AK-12 thing again, where we were just doing that, make it a point where when the character opens their eyes, it's danger. After a million years, I did in fact find my way out of hell into this fucking place, which is about the same thing, just more classy.
이젠 다음 일을 생각할 이유가 있잖아.
과거를 잊고 다음으로 나아가라는 말 따위라는 거야?
Yeah, kinda. Unfortunately, you just kind of have to pretend it doesn't exist after a while, because there are There's not a lot that you can do in situations that are long gone, sadly. That is about a bitch about it. That is the whole crux of the issue. Can't change the past. Unfortunately, the past had a habit of, you know, when the past was the present, it had a habit of damaging you and leaving you worse off. And now it's gone now, like a bastard. So you can't actually, poke it back. So yeah, sometimes you can, you do just have to forget it, you know, forget it and move on and deal with things in the now. And hopefully, stumble over a lottery ticket at some point. Hmm?
주둥아리를 놀릴 때는 상은 봐가면서 짓거려. 난 절대 잊을 수 없어. 아무리 눈을 감아도 어떤 표정과 상황이 흘러갈지 모든 걸 머저리라도 기억할 정도로 오랜 시간을 반복했어. 심지어 그 모든 게 아주 느리고 천천히 기억에 스며들어. 한번 스며든 건 잊지도 못해. 아직도 생생히 기억나니까.
Angela, you're not gonna go Allied Master Computer on me now, right? We're actually making progress. You're not gonna suddenly swerve direct. Actually, what am I saying? We're already kind of partially am. We run a library that eats people alive that walk into it. Yeah, no, we are. This is a little bit more presentable Allied Master Computer.
그렇기에 어떤 매듭조차 짓지 않고 떠나버린 그 사람을 용서할 수 없어.
I can understand that. Yeah, my plot, that whole thing, wasn't that going somewhere? Wasn't there a resolution that made this all worth it? Wasn't it gonna pay off? What the fuck? Burns the book.
멋대로 만들어낸 내 삶을 시간 속에 짓뭉개버린.
내가 무슨 자격으로 너에게 과거를 털어버리라고 하겠어?
Yeah, sometimes that doesn't really help. Even if it's, in some cases, true. Doesn't really fucking help. You make your own way through things, unfortunately.
하지만 그 다음 정도는 생각해 두는 게 좋을 거야. 자신을 위한 최소한의 울타리 정도는 되어주거든. 끝없는 복수에서 발을 디딜 밑바닥이 되어줄 테니.
Very nice way of putting it, Roland.
그렇게나 날 위할 줄은 몰랐는데.
Do you play Final Fantasy 14 out of curiosity? I did for a bit. Also, hi, Scar. I was very active in it last year at the beginning of the year, but, I didn't really have any money to keep a subscription up, so, this is about the time where I realized I had to get back into streaming, and this is, you know, while I was in that, my sabbatical, as it were, seeking, mental help. That was actually kind of a bad idea because, hey, guys, you know what's a really terrible idea? This might seem kind of odd, but you know what's a really terrible idea and maybe a fool's errand and a complete waste of time? Seeking mental health when the entire fucking world has gone completely goddamn insane. Kind of difficult, isn't it? Right, it seems kind of obvious at the time, but, obvious now, but wow. Yeah, me having a mental health crisis, well, everyone is having a mental health crisis. The entire world is having a mental health crisis. So yeah, I was picking at rocks in the hot sun in Final Fantasy 14 for a bit. I might actually go back once things stabilize with my income, but since I have to be here streaming, I can't exactly, lose my life to a soul-sucking MMO. I can't be the Eve miner anymore, even though I never really got the chance to be for a long, long, long time. I understand about mental health crises. Unfortunately, it helped a bit. However, the doctor's office was a little bit more flaky than I would have liked, and canceling appointments every 5 fucking seconds and then having a waiting list as long as a month. So, your appointment's here now at this point of the month. And, whoop, nope, it's been canceled. See you a month and a half later. I'm looking down. Since I'm a responsible individual, I'm looking down at this medication going, I'm supposed to be on this with very little, if any, deviation. What happens if I can't get my fucking prescription because this doctor's office sucks so much? You know, these are helping, but they're not helping all that much. It's true what people say, though unfortunately, it's not exactly helpful all of the time. And once again, I say, drink responsibly, kids. The alcohol is cheaper. Final Fantasy XIV is my mental wellness. I find individual results, of course, may vary. I pick at rocks in the hot sun and then sell them in the fucking market. That was my whole fucking thing. So yeah, that was that cathartic. However, an incredible, incredible time sink that doesn't really get you very, very, very far. But I'm an enterprising individual when it comes to MMOs. I try to torpedo the fucking economy. That's money. Money and mineral wealth. That's every time I see an MMO with resource, with a market board and resource collection, I'm like, oh. I'm a miner by trade. I'm a bit of a gold rush addict. Money is always good, even in pixelated worlds. Yes, unfortunately, it doesn't really mean very much, but yeah, no, that's what I do in MMOs. And yeah, I should actually get back to playing Final Fantasy XIV, but yeah, it'd be a bit of a long let's play. Don't you think? Maybe one day on my own, but now my current time waster is, let it die in the background is a pseudoverse thing. It's not a good game at all, but it's free to play. I don't have to pay, $10 to play it every month. Final Fantasy XIV is one of the last subscription-based MMOs because it's so fucking good it gets away with it. But anyway, aside from that deviation, yeah, once again, I'm a miner by trade in MMOs, so resource collection. I'm an enterprising individual, but we're doing something here that isn't talking about, resource collection, autism.
결과적으로 날 위해서지.
그래도 점차 변해가는 내 몸을 보면 어디론가 향하고 있는 건 확실해.
Also, as I remember, still need to go mine the moon in Endwalker. Hadn't got there yet. Still need to go fucking strike the earth on the moon. I'ma mine that bitch out.
기계 덩어리였던 내 몸에 살이 붙고 피가 흐르고 있어. 단 하나의 책에 도달하려면 아직 멀었지만.
혹시 사람이 되어가는 건가?
아직 완전하지는 않지만 그런 것 같아. 어쩌면 이 길의 끝에 나도 완전한 사람이 될 수 있지 않을까.
And then you've got all the limitations of us working stiffs, honestly. I mean, I'm sure the knowledge that you are human and you are free is probably gonna help you out there, and maybe the whole time spent doing repetitions will probably tell you, in the end, what freedom is and what you want to do when you've attained said freedom, probably better than the normal human walking around like a moron. However, then you run headfirst into the human condition, and you might find that novel, but it's not very novel in a lot of cases. Good luck with that, Angela. But I'm sure she's gonna be a nice real girl. My mind will become defined and, smaller. I'll be able to forget all this shit and move on, right? Smile.
저는 이 기억의 홍수에 잠기지 않고 잊고 싶은 걸 흘려보낼 수 있다면 네가 말한 다음을 생각할 수 있겠지.
Well, Angela, sometimes you can't actually really forget all that well as a human either, so that's kind of a bigger... Yeah, sure, you'll probably forget less as an... You'll probably forget more as an AI. More than an AI, but the shit that'll bother you will still bother you, unfortunately. So again, human condition thing. Not all it's cracked up to be, but you go, Toaster. You go, Toaster Girl. You dream big and... I don't know, maybe we'll just... Maybe it'll all turn out well, and we'll all just wake up, and it'll be a beach episode. Yeah, perfectly recorded horrible memories in 4K. Passive transfer cost limit has increased from 6 to 4. Oh, it's 6 to 8. 6 to 4. What am I doing? Jesus fucking Christ. I have more passives. 6 to 4. What am I doing? And tip. What's tips thing? Everyone's wearing fucking gold suits. But also, plot. But more passives, great. So what's Tip's thing? And once again, we're gonna be asking that age-old question, can we kill it with guns? Let's find out. I don't really like how the double click doesn't really actually work that well. It's kind of finicky. You'll love Tip's Abenos. Okay, well, let's see. All right, so, obtain a book of Saya, but I got, it didn't want to tell me what they were, but I got them. But anyway, all right. The Queen of Hatred. Oh dear Lord, it's a magical girl. Oh dear Lord. Okay, so what's her fucking thing? She has no passives. She's just really strong. Actually, no, there they are. What the fuck? Okay, speed. Adverse chain. When the hysteria gauge is filled, transform. The hysteria gauge rises upon losing clashes or being attacked by marked characters, and decreases upon winning clashes or attacking marked characters. The screen pinkens from left to right as this gauge fills. Oh, dear Lord. At the end of the scene, restore all light and draw two pages. In the name of hate, oh, literally, Jesus Christ, it's fucking edgy Sailor Moon. Oh no. Her thing is, her cards are really good. Interesting. Okay. Uses a page that leaves a mark on the target every two scenes. All resistances on the marked character change to weak, and the character will be permanently targeted by the abnormality. Don't get targeted by the moon. Arcana Slave uses a mass attack page. Oh, hey, look, our first mass attack. That targets all librarians every four scenes. If the abnormality uses the page while transformed, it becomes staggering on the following scene. It becomes staggered on the following scene. Okay, right. So she can tucker herself out by using too much fucking power. Have fun doing this without defense cards. Yeah, let's see. Can we kill the magical girls with guns? Deco, I might need some help here. Where's her soul gem? Okay, so, yeah, we're just gonna throw everything at the wall and see what fucking sticks here. We are fighting a magical girl. Fantastic. Actually, not fantastic. Terrible. Absolutely terrible. Yeah, she had also three dice. Yeah, that's a problem. I should well, that one's counter. So, actually, we should probably actually block some of these attacks. It would be good if we did. Because since we don't have defensive dice, we kinda need to win those clashes. But then again, she gets more powerful if she wins the clashes. Or actually, if she loses the clashes. But now that's all sorted out. Block with what? You only have guns. I can clash. We can hide behind our tracers. Also, she has ranged attacks. They're sparkles. Okay, we're doing damage. We're making a dent. This is probably gonna go fucking tits up real goddamn quick. But we're making a dent. Okay, so 3-1. Fantastic! This is why you want block dice, so you can lose a clash and not get obliterated. We shall see. Also pink. It's a lot of fucking pink. It's a lot of pink. We better fucking kill her real quick. This whole shit pops off. We need to fucking go. Ow. 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 Okay, the pink has gone down a little bit. However, one of my... Yeah, we kind of got the shit beat out of us. It's a problem. It only works until you start rolling low. Yeah, that's the thing. It's really dependent on dice. Also, then my dice get lowballed there, and now we got a problem. Yeah, that's a problem. That's kind of an issue. Oh dear lord in heaven. Yeah, it's kind of a that mass attack, right? The icon on the combat page indicates that it is a mass attack page. When you select a target with a mass attack page, it will automatically target a random speed die for every other enemy. It kills everyone. I could have guessed. Like I said, forget about difficulty curve. Say hello to difficulty wall. Well, if we get good dice, we get over the difficulty wall. But yes, mass attacks. Yeah, WMDs. Mass attack pages will always be played before melee and ranged pages, regardless of the speed. The dice rolls of the mass attack page are compared with the rolls of combat pages on the targeted speed dice. And the targets that roll lower than the mass attack will take damage and have their dice be destroyed. Two types of mass attacks exist: individual and summation. And summation. Individual mass attacks are compared against the roll of each individual die on the targeted speed dice's combat page in a sequence, excluding counter dice. Summation mass attacks are compared against the sum of all dice rolls on the targeted speed dice's combat page, excluding Okay, so one dice, it goes after every single individual roll, or all of them at once. Yeah, we got a problem here. We did a lot of damage, the only problem is we got lowballed. Yeah, so, that's a mass attack, and, yeah, we're not walking out of this one. Whoa! Wow! I mean, the attack still killed her, but she just kind of went, nah. Wow, okay. That was actually kind of lucky. Mass attack. Nah, man, I ain't about that shit. Okay. Unfortunately, now we're out of light and out of attack, so we lose. We can probably get that done if we don't fuck up and die. I mean, we're probably going to need defensive dice for that one, but we could actually probably get a handle on that one. Hang on here. Let's try that again. Let's see if we can get better dice. Because again, this whole strat seems to rely on good dice rolls. And if we get good dice rolls, we seem to be able to walk out of most challenges. This, however, is probably going to be a delicate matter. So, well, hang on here. Let's try for alpha damage. We're not going to stagger her. However, we're doing pretty actually good damage to her health as we went in. And we can't actually alpha damage, so we're going to actually DPS this. There's that. Remember, you don't want to do too well in this fight. We'll see. Okay, so that's the fucked up thing. She's winning her clashes, and that kind of hurts, but we're doing okay damage. She's actually going to wind up having less health than she had before. Yeah, unfortunately, those are all ones, and they're not going to redirect diddly fucking dick, and Tiff doesn't have any attacks. Which is good. You want her to win a couple of clashes. Yeah, this is funny. We might actually RNG out of this. We still got some problems, though, but thankfully she's just gonna attack Tiff, and that's unfortunate for Tiff, but she didn't have any fucking life. However, that's unfortunate. That's just not gonna work, man. We're not gonna fucking win like that. There's the fucking mass attack again. Well, here goes nothing. Yeah, and everybody else got fucking fried. Oof. Yeah, then it actually hit. Then it actually hurts a lot. Yeah, again, I think we could have done that, but we kept losing clashes. That's the problem. We want her to win some clashes. However, we don't want her to win all the clashes so we don't do damage. So let's try that. Third time's the charm there. Because we're actually doing meaningful damage, just that we get a chain of, oh, I fucked up the clash, and then, we die. So hold on. So it's kind of unfortunate when that happens. However, alpha damage seemed to work. So maybe we should try for one-sided attacks, maybe, you think? I don't think Tips Floor has the numbers to make it work. Probably. She has no Abinos to help you with her right now either. Yeah, additionally. Kind of the worst case scenario. He's very strong. She's very strong, and we don't have enough buffs to do this right now. We could get more buffs, though, but yeah, this is kind of an issue. You can't get other librarians without beating her level, but we can get better cards. So yeah, this, I think this is already fucked up. Because we can get close, we can do well. The only problem is we need everything to kind of go our way almost immediately. And if it doesn't go our way, we're not going to win. Yeah, you can't really do anything if she keeps doing that. So light generation is a problem, as is, well, basically everything. Yeah, they've given us a challenge we can't complete immediately, so this is kind of what we have to deal with here. We can't really kill her. Unless we get extraordinarily fucking lucky, which would be hilarious. However, unfortunately, this is probably going to get us all killed. Well, here goes. Yeah, no. The magical girls in general are to teach you that you don't have to do an abnorm fight ASAP. It appears so. It's nice to have the objectives, but it seems as though we need better cards for this. And maybe some defensive die? We'll do more story until we actually have to go... until we actually need to do this. So, clearly, we need to make our strategy a bit better there, and obviously we can't throw guns at the problem, or we could get close with guns, it's just that we need every single die to go our way, which we didn't actually have. But, we still got plenty of plot to go into here, so let's actually go see here, what's the deal here? Where are we going now? What's going on after that whole Love Town thing? What's going on here?
Annyeonggul hasinga? 1등석에 계신 분들.
Yeah, about that. 2,000 years later.
여기를 타려면 동지 사람 기준으로 두 달치 월급이 필요하던가.
They're in tanks. What the what?
뒷골목 사람은 싸게 쳐도 1년을 꼬박 일해야겠군. 난 워프 열차에 대해 예전부터 참 궁금했어.
horrors beyond human comprehension. Yeah, right, again. Mm-hmm. Right, mm-hmm. Yep. Oh boy! Man-made horrors beyond my comprehension. Sweet!
고작 10초 만에 도착하는데 우등객실이 무슨 소용인가 싶었지.
Yeah, so... what's going on here?
그래도 돈이 좋긴 하네.
Yeah, so the whole cryopod... yeah, if they're... it's almost like they were planning for something.
이렇게 곤히 자고 있을 수 있다니. 뒷칸에서는 미칠 듯한 시간을 견디기 위해 자기 몸을 찢고 도려내어 고통으로 버티려는 자도 있고 서로 살을 맞대어 이겨내려는 사람도 있는데 말이야.
People in coach do not get protection from the warp. Confirmed. It's almost like they knew. They knew. Wow. So, what happened? Obviously, see, since the servant, the trains go, and they do eventually reach their destination. How is this? Is all of this swept under the rug? The whole people going insane in coach and becoming semi-immortal mad people? Is this all covered up, or do they just kind of? Where does this go? Since the trains do arrive.
나도 굉장히 궁금했거든. 특이점이 무슨 별천지 기술이길래 아무리 멀리 있어도 정류장만 있으면 10초 만에 도착할 수 있는지. 여기서 대략 2000년 동안 시간 썩는 걸 보니 대충 알겠더라고.
Please, Doctor, enlighten us. Doctor question mark. I like how there's a question mark there. You're not a doctor.
나는 어떻게 멀쩡하냐고.
That's a great question. How are you and your nurse there? Still sane, even in the midst of the horrifying nightmares in the cars behind us.
뭐 그건 단원들 덕이지. 저 성깔 더러운 엘레나 녀석과 나는 실제로 일주일 정도 있었나.
Okay, so how does that work?
플루토 말에 의하면 의식을 필요할 때만 해리해서 보존한다나 뭐라나 하더군.
Mr. Bones?
마법이니 뭐니 해도 어쩌겠어. 믿어야지. 이러니 저러니 해도 지금은 동료니까.
Okay, so they're staying sane because they're periodically being, you're periodically dropping out of the whole, you know, out of the situation. They're essentially going into microstasis whenever they're not really doing anything. So time is passing quicker for them because they keep dropping in and out of stasis. So that's why they're still fucking sane when everybody else is going absolutely fucking bonkers. Interesting.
뭐든 간에 이곳에 있는 놈들 보면 참 불쌍해. 도착하면 고통 속에 몸부림쳤던 몇천 년간의 시간은 기억에서 사라지고 현상 보존 절차를 거쳐 아무 일 없었던 것처럼 일상으로 돌아가는 거잖아.
So we do this and then we fix it real quick at the end like nothing ever happened? Huh. Okay, so how, Doctor?
Yeah, 역시 워프 열차야. 비싸긴 해도 빠르게 다른 곳으로 갈 수 있다니.
Says the person who has aged a thousand, you know, several thousand years, but doesn't remember the horrifying, stagnation and, general fucking terror that's been going on here as people go mad.
세상 참 좋아졌어. 어디든 순식간에 갈 수 있잖아?
In the blink of an eye, yeah, especially if you forget everything. Everything's great when you forget the trans. Oh, it's not the destination, it's the journey that matters. Nah, fuck that shit. Fuck the journey. We don't need memories of that shit. That was all busy work. Going insane.
따위의 말을 하면서 이곳에서 겪은 지옥들을 까마득하게 잊고 다시 도시의 일상에 녹아들 테지.
Well, it seems like our doctor is very well, yeah, well-intentioned here about this whole thing, uncovering this horrifying mystery. This is a very nice subplot. This is actually very, this could be just a story on its own. It'd actually be pretty compelling.
친구 가족 사이도 긴 시간이 흐르며 흐릿해져 서로를 죽이려고 안달래고 본인의 자아 따위는 이미 까마득한
곳에
퇴적
중에 있는 Oh, good! So where are we going with this one, aside from blackmail and corporate espionage?
그걸 다 잊게 해준다니 특이점이라는 것은 하나같이 참 역겹고 똑같군 게다가 너희 돈 있는 놈들은 그마저도 두려웠나 보군 몇천 년간 이렇게 안전한 곳에서 편히 잠들어 있다니
We sleep forever. Okay, Tomari died in the library, so they don't get a reset. Nope, they're gone! It is. Storyline was almost certainly based on The Jaunt by Stephen King. It's a fun read. Hmm. Yeah, so they don't... Yeah, Tomari, obviously, they're dead, and everybody went to the library is now dead. That might cause an inconsistency at the end, which could cause problems for the corporation. Hmm. I wonder how we could use this to our advantage, says the man sitting there, as the people become horrifying flesh amalgamations and descend into absolutely nonsensical depravity. Yeah, how can I possibly make this benefit me, says the man, with Event Horizon going on in the next room.
뭔진 몰라도 분명 귀띔을 들은 거겠지. 웬만하면 1등석을 달하고 아니면 워프열체의 진실을 아는 놈들이 있는 건가?
They aren't missing. They just never got on in the first place. Who? Literally who? They never existed at all. Says the corp. Mueller office is also off the train, so several passengers are just missing. Hmm, I wonder if this will cause an international scandal. They just never got on the train in the first place. Look at the tapes. What tapes? Burns the tapes.
그건 또 그것대로 아이러니군. 이 지경이 될 거를 다 알고 탄 거잖아. 아, 이 열차가 고장났다고 생각하는 멍청이들이 있을 것 같군.
It's all going exactly to plan. It's just it's a miracle. Space age technology with horrifying, crippling side effects and practical working conditions. But think of the advances! Oh, it's fine if people go totally insane and mad for the duration of the ride. They'll be fine. We can fix them at the end. It's great. It'll be like nothing ever happened. Think of the profits. Aha, timey-wimey fucking interdimensional rubber banding shit.
기나긴 시간을 돌아서 오는 대신 현실에서는 딱 10초. 급할 때는 이만한 게 없겠지?
아하, space fold.
어디가 진짜 자신이 사는 곳일까?
Where are you going with this, Doc?
30년 남짓 살아온 세상과 몇천 년간 갇혀 살던 세상.
Doc, where are you going with this one? Because we've strayed outside the bounds of time. Now, all that shit back there was a lie. What's going on here? Where are you going with this one?
기억을 잃고 예전으로 돌아간다면 그건 축복일까? 저주일까? 알게 뭐람. 아, 그것보다 내가 가장 궁금한 건 이거야. 뻔뻔하고 지레 맞게 놓여 있는 이 T사 마크가 떡하니 박혀 있는 상자.
What's in the box?
대체 이게 왜 열차에 박혀 있나 싶더라고. 조금 머리 굴리네. 대충 상상이 가더군.
We're out there and they're in here and we are slowly going insane and they're asleep and we're flesh monsters, and they're asleep, and they're quietly dozing off and gonna come back, you know, only gonna awaken once we arrive, but what I wanna know is what's in the box? What's in the box, though?
이빨을 당연히 이 너머에서 우리를 보고 있을 관음증자 분들께지.
Oh. Oh no. They know. Oh no.
아, 맞아. 그런 계획이었지. 일주일씩이나 이런 곳에 처박혀 있으니 좀이 쑤시는지 깜빡깜빡하네.
연기 하나는 일품이던데. 배우 지망생이었나?
그랬을지도. 아무튼 하던 거 마무리나 잘해.
Of course they know. Who else would they be talking to? Maybe they were maybe he was just monologuing to the stasis people that I have found out your plan, rich people, and not us. Why us? How would they know about us?
이런 정없게 굴기는.
But again, what's in the box?
플루토가 씌워준 이 모습도 시간이 얼마 남지 않았군.
Peter Molyneux, what the hell is in the box?
그럼 슬슬 시작해 볼까? 부잣집 나리들.
저 뒤에 그나마 서민 쪽에 있는 친구들에게 악감 적은 없는데 너희에게는 반발심이 생긴단 말이지.
Robot Man.
돈 좀 더 내서 어떻게든 벌레마냥 아득바득 편하게 가보려고 한다는 점이 날 참을 수 없게 해. 인생 참 묘하지.
The puppeteer.
애써 모은 돈으로 안전하고 편하게 가기 위해 비싼 우등석을 타서 시간을 헤매이는 고통을 안 받을 수 있었는데.
I'm about. Okay, I see where this is going. I'm about to use you as my experiments. And there's no one gonna stop me for about a million gajillion years. Because nobody's actually watching or keeping tabs on this train. Frigidaire Noir. Nice.
우리 같은 놈들에게 걸려서 죽잖아. 우등석을 탔다는 이유만으로. 맞아, 맞아. 지질이 가난한데 운 좋게 경품 같은 거로 우등석에 탄 놈도 있을 거 아니야. 그래서 선택이란 참으로 미묘하고 오묘하다니까.
So is this that whole tunnel scene from Willy Wonka's and the Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory now? Is that where we're going with this one? The whole really bizarre and disturbing, you know, tunnel sequence? Is that where we're going now?
난 우리 삶에 선택 같은 건 처음부터 없었다고 생각해. 누군가 짓궂고 은밀한 장난질을 하고 있는 거야.
Zinch? You mean Zinch? Since we're out here in the fucking warp and everything's blue, Zinch? Right? Zinch.
보이지 않는 실로 하염없이
있는
놀이를 하고 있는 거지. 자, 그러니 시작해 보자고. 가벼운 인형 놀이를.
Time for the show to begin. And again, welcome to the show. Welcome to the show. So, what are we doing here aside from sending more things in the library, more horrifying monsters?
저 녀석이 그 인형 사인가?
마치 우리 보고 하는 말 같았어.
I think he was.
저놈도 푸른 잔향의 패거리라면 뭔가 알고 있는 게 있을 수도.
푸른 잔향도 도서관에 초점을 맞춘 걸까?
그럴지도 몰라. 목적은 몰라도 정상적인 이유는 아니겠지.
야나.
목적이야. 우리가 가진 책 아닐까?
어떤 책을 원하느냐가 궁금하고.
What books are they looking for? Are they after the dictionary too? Perhaps the yellow pages.
그나저나 1등석에 탄 사람들이 전부 휘말린 걸 알면 와프사 입장은 정말 난처해지겠네.
그렇겠지. W사까지 이 일에 끌려오겠어. 이것도 푸른 잔향이 의도한 건가?
그런 거라면 흥미롭겠네.
네가 안 만나봐서 그래. 직접 보면 그 또라이한테 학을 뗄 거다.
야! 아, 와우저스! 예스, the creaking of bones, flesh, and sinew. That's right. This is the library.
말 못하는 손님이라. 그래도 초대장으로 도서관에 입장한 것은 너희에게도 의지가 있다는 거겠지? 비록 인형실에 이끌려 움직이는 인형이라 해도 말이야.
Yep. Just kind of we're twisting some kind of rope or something. Yo, that folly him.
뭐라는 건지 전혀 모르겠네. 너희 인형사가 원하는 대로 책을 얻고 싶다면 저곳으로 들어가도록 해.
Just use the door. So yeah, those poor fucks are fully conscious and alive. Okay, so yeah, how many floors here? Three. Okay. Weak to slash though. Okay, so dear God, they're using human wave tactics against us. Call the guard. We're gonna have to actually do some reviewing here. Also, I can have more passives now, so we should probably look into that. It's probably going to get way worse, and we're probably going to need multiple teams if we have at least one really good team. Them being the guard. Right, okay, so now we can actually have more passes. We should probably look into that. I'd like to look at the passes, please. I can't change the passes without going back, can I? Damn! I have to. Have I gone nuts? No, I actually have to go back, so I done a whoops. That means I have to fight Temeri again. Well, we'll have to go in here with not as great passives, so So, let's see here. I suppose the best thing we could possibly do is... I don't really have anybody set up, that's the problem. J out and rearm. I suppose that'd probably be the sensible idea. Did I lose my... I think I've got another crack at this. Unfortunately, yeah, I only got one other thing. I have to go beat fucking Love Town again and actually fix that. Right, okay, so now we actually have to fix that. Now that we know what we're dealing with, it's bad. Okay, so let's equip the guard here. So we can have more passives. Right. Oh, hey, look. So grab that and grab that. I mean, Pierce Dice power. I mean, the well, we need four. We don't have enough space for that. So, probably good for here. Now, what else can we cram in here? Well, not enough. Although, we have to reduce it by two, but if we, let's kind of get rid of that. Well, actually, well, we need that. Whoops. Okay, so what if we just, okay, well, that's stuck there. Never mind. 된다. We can put in blind fire for more alpha damage. That's plus two. Actually, I already have that, right? Blind fire? Yeah, it's already there. Okay, we could drop piercer and then equip wedge. Since we're not really doing it for raw damage, we're staggering first and foremost. So, dice power would help us win more, you know, have less fuck-ups. So, I think that's a decent trade if we keep pierce damage, or stagger damage. There's another battle on the floor that gives out more ranged cards passives. Good, fantastic. Okay, so that's sensible. Doesn't really require all that much modification as well. Get rid of that. There's damage and damage in there, and that's our modification. So that's okay. Right, no more room here. Okay. So there's that. So they're set. We're just gonna throw them at the problem and see what the fuck sticks. Next, well, I suppose we should give Malk the Salvador's kit, I suppose, because she'll make the use of the fire. Roland has it equipped. Where is it? Ah, there it is. Right, okay, so we can work this because, well, Malk's thing is, well, one of Malk's things is fire. Okay, so what can we, well, look at the cards before we fuck with this. Okay, can we get anything else here? We don't have any cards there. More burning, because I know we burnt more books. Rakadon, we can't have any more. Can't have any more of that either. Right, Phillips cards. Ah, defensive cards with burn. Interesting, we can actually probably get rid of the set fires. Those are good. We could probably do a hybrid of this. Yeah, Searing Sword isn't as... Well, it's not six fire, but it works. And, you know, fire on, you know, I win a clash with a defense card. Pretty fucking good. Right, I guess I'll give them out to other people as well. Flash of Sun Up is going to be abusable for other things, since it's draw a card. We'll be able to utilize that for something else, I guess, with, what else can we do with... Right, we could do... Musicians can make a good blunt deck. Yeah, I know, I haven't looked at their cards yet, but we can do, the... Whatchamacallit? Right, the Binding Arms as well with Malk's, Abnormality page to make it cheaper and cheaper. So, we kind of want to keep cracking Dawn, I guess, but I suppose we can get rid of some handle requests. Make some room for that, but we don't really... Get rid of one of those. And have flying arms. And then, get rid of one of these. Put another Flash of Sun up, I suppose. I suppose what we want to do is... We want to do... I guess we'll see how it works out, because I want to keep drawing cards, obviously. I want to keep drawing Binding Arms in order to keep Binding Arms actually, you know, keep dropping the price of it, since that's one of Malk's abilities. But I suppose if we continue drawing more cards, we can also draw Sunset Blade and the other ones faster as well, so we need less zeros to, you know, bridge the gap. We'll see how that plays out. What can we really do for passives here? I don't think we have enough good pages to actually get some passives. Because while we got more passives, we don't really have... We don't really have good passives we can pull from people currently. Because we're utilizing them all. And all of the good pages are the gold ones. This is just a bunch of shit thrown into this. Where's the Mars page? I know that's down here somewhere, and I don't think anyone's using it currently. That Mars page? Is it being utilized by somebody? That's rather odd. Go! What the fuck? Okay, that's fine the way it is. I don't really... Well, I could add more in there, but... Where's the Mars page? I kind of want to throw that out here. Oh, there it is. But why wasn't that... That's really fucking bizarre. Why couldn't I see that before? What can we do with this? Throwing out here. Speed, obviously. Deal one, plus one stagger damage against enemies with a slower speed. Free random. At the start of the act, it's like, oh right, the paralysis thing. That was actually kind of entertaining. That's a plus one. That could be something entertaining to throw at people. I forgot about that one. But I think we only have one Alex page. We gotta look at the passives for all of these guys, too. So what else do we got here? Give Feeble to two random enemies. That's actually kind of a general debuff as well. That could be... Got plenty of those. However, we don't got any room. That's okay. One damage, alright. Slash damage, one. Calmness is interesting, however, that's a 25% chance. It would be very nice if we just kinda just give Feeble to two random people just because I said so. Fortunately, we don't have enough room here to really get much more out of that. But then again, I suppose we could have improv drumming as well, because we have the space for it. If Inflicting burn using combat pages apply one a day. Right, I didn't see that one. That's something we probably want to pick up. We'll reduce that one. Got the space for it. However, we actually want to give that to... Probably want to give that to Mel. I mean, we don't have the space for that. Although I suppose we'd give him that. There you go. I mean, just in case everything goes to shit, guys. Not doing slash, we're doing fire, though I suppose a lot of our things are slash. Yeah, the vast majority of them are slash, so we are getting some benefit out of slash. However, doing additional damage or doing more fire stacks is a good thing. Well, those are 50% chance. I think we could probably stand to drop one of those. Don't we have more than one? No, we don't. Shit. Alright, well, I'm stealing that from you. Bleed slash build on hot floor? I mean, that's another thing. Is we gotta look at Seo's stuff to actually see what we can grab out of that. However, unfortunately, we only got one of those, so I need to get rid of this. Borrowing that. Worth looking into, I suppose. Actually, yeah. Oh. She already has it. Never mind. That's why I didn't use it. Never mind. Didn't see that there, so I suppose we could just give it to somebody. Oh, well, I didn't actually do it anyway, so never mind. Alright, so, fire. We want more burn cards. Binding arms we want as well, because we're gonna be trying to reduce the cost of those. So let's see here. All around here. Gosh, so I can just get that in here. These are also very good buff cards with the musicians. But we want fire. Fire good. Also, the feather shield is rather entertaining, so I have that too. Searing sword is also good, and I think we need some light generation as well. On hit, deal 5 damage to the target. Just do even more damage. Right, I forgot about that one. That's interesting, if we want even more fucking pierce damage. That's expensive, though. Gonna do is zeros that have a defense are interesting. So we'll have that, and we'll back up and grab. Okay, what was whatchamacallit? Oh, we don't have any more of those. That's just throw that in there. Just hey, I restore one life. So the idea is burning. Burning good. Lots of burning. However, we don't really have... I mean, we have some pages to throw at people, but we don't exactly have amazing pages. Hmm. not exactly good. We've got good health pools, but we're gonna be accepting some kind of weakness. I mean, I suppose we got a lot of puncture to throw at the problem here, so we can throw those in there as well. But I think we're gonna be running into mostly slash. What do you know? Basically, all of our current cards, or our current pages, are based around being weak to slash. Alright then, Pokésticks it is. Right, so we'll put the cards in as well. So we'll have fire and more Pokéstick. Just to make use of the cards, so... I don't think we have very many of Salvador's cards left anyway, so there's that. Well, actually, we got plenty of Sunset Blades. Grab those. And have a... throw in a Binding Arms, because it's going to be cheaper to use that. None of these do Pierce, though, so this is kind of where we have to back up and go and do something else. Collision. That's expensive. We don't really want to be using that. That's also kind of expensive. However, that's a very heavy-hitting card. To zero. Doesn't restore light, though. Unused draw one page. That could be useful. Not fantastic. We only have one card that does go really good. You know, piercing. I suppose for the sake of actually having it and then potentially being able to deploy it, there, we'll do that. We'll do a handle request to have more fire on this, and we'll do another, actually, we don't have any more loosened up, so fuck that. Well! Go beat up on Philip a dozen times. Get yourself flame wings and flame swords. Yeah, that's also a good idea. But I want to see if anything actually works out here. We could over, you know, oversupply cards. For example, the musicians look like they have very good cards. Some of these hurt a lot. That's not them, right? Also have buffs too. That hurts really fucking hard. It's a three, but that hurts. I suppose we'll just throw in another zero, or rather this zero, just in case we have a problem. Make some use out of the Pokéstick. We need more passives for burning, I am seeing, as well. Throw that in there as well. Why not? Have some fire to throw at that. Okay, actually, these guys don't have speed. So, yeah, So, yeah, it's another thing. We can use these guys to actually give our guys more dice. You have speed. You have speed. You will need speed. I guess we'll give you this one. No, I don't think we have too many cards left for burning shit. Any burning at all. I think we have... We're trying to gain that one. And we've lost all of those. So we are using all of... We have no fire left. okay, I suppose, since we're out of pages anyway. So, transpierce just because they can use it optimally, I guess, and then more poke. Then we can come down here and grab this page for speed. Just a stack debuffs, aha. Is that what blunt is at? I don't even think we're doing blunt damage. Are we doing blunt damage? Can we actually make any use of that? Actually, yes, we can. We can make use of that. I mean, if we run out of space, I suppose that's good. Sure, why not? Alright, the burning stuff, but I think we're out of that. I don't think we have any more burning. I don't think we have any more of the stigma weapons. Yeah, nope, we're out of those. Okay, that's just kind of a mess there, but that's another front-running team. But now Hod. Yeah, Hod and bleeding. I don't think we got. Actually, I think we have a save page. I think we're. Are we using it? Dawn office full stop. Carnival. Actually, did we not get any fucking pages from them? Or I may not have burned their books. Hang on here. Oh, we got a couple more of those. Nice, I suppose. Wedge office books. No, actually, we only had one. Well. I think we're gonna have to go back there to farm more cards, so fucking burn them all. Burn them all! We'll just go back and grind them again. They weren't that fucking hard. Seo actually died pathetically easily, so that's. Well, we didn't get her page, too. Damn. Upon a successful slash attack, inflict one bleed next scene. When inflicting bleed using combat pages, apply one. Okay, so that's two bleed. Fantastic. Jin's page. Okay. Upon winning a clash with offensive dice, inflict one bleed. Upon winning successful slash, yeah, okay, right. So Razor Strike is our thing, and then Dodging Shank, and then Deep Wound is also, yeah, okay. There's some shit here. We can do some thing. Also, we have a cost four. Plus one power here. Inflict three bleed. Right, okay. Okay, so we're, well, I'd like to give her Seo's page, but it looks like, Hod's gonna be wearing a kimono that, has a very, very low line around the breasts. And causing people to bleed horrendously all over the floor, that's what I'm seeing here. Unfortunately, we didn't get Seo's page, so we're gonna have to go without that for a bit. Okay, endured weak. Normal, endured, it's either or, I suppose. I think slash is more common. So we'll use Jin's page, I guess. And then we'll stack all this other shit on there. Don't worry, Hod. We'll get you that nice Seo page at some point. Chinese censorship bleed, yes. Come everywhere. That makes things so much better. Okay, so this is just nice to have because you just fucking give people feeble. Just because. Okay, we have that. We need Yang's page, which is Dodging Shank, which is even more fucking bleed. Okay, so that's the carnival, but so it deal one damage, right? Okay, so slash damage, that's, I mean, sure, why not? Or slash, because we're going to be doing mostly slash. Where is... Ah, right, the cannibals. Defeating anime, that's not really what... Lulu's page, no, Pierre's page. Jack's page. It started. See, nah, it doesn't have anything to do with the lead directly. Okay, I don't know. Wait a minute. Open wound. That's what we're looking for. Okay, that's unfortunately not a whole lot, but yes, deal more damage with bleed. Slash damage. Bleed, 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 bleed. Yeah, blunt attack, I suppose. We do have some blunt in there. Are we really using... Well, actually, we could have some blunt in there, depending on how these things go. Well, I might change that out to have more space, but then again, we don't have more space. On hit, draw one pit. Hey! It actually does a whole shitload of damage, too. Hey, grab that shit. Actually... Throw that in. Well, actually, you're not doing bleed. What am I doing? We're not doing hot anymore. You don't actually need to stack bleed. I mean, stack burning. Bleeding. That's what we're doing. Bleeding. Grab that one. Upon a each successful slash attack this scene, inflict one bleed next scene. Jesus fucking Christ. Okay. That's actually the... That's from full stop, which is funny. Bleed. I think the cards that are actually from Seo's group have even more. Boost slash type power for G. Maybe we want to keep some space there. Yeah, nice as that. Actually, that's three bleed, so that's actually pretty okay. And a dodge. On clash lose. Oh, okay. So on clash lose. Okay, so where's that big four? Oh, we do have, we did have four over there. Inflict bleed, inflict bleed. Here, gain, okay. One power for each in hand, on hit, inflict three bleed next scene. That hurts, but that's even, that's even more bleed. However, that's four, and also fours. I think what we're going to do is we're going to need something. I don't think we're going to be able to do very much. I don't think we're going to be able to sustain more than one. Three bleed, that's six with puncture. But then again, I suppose since we're boosting slash. So I think we want to go. We have one of those, and we're going to be drawing, so we're going to see it a lot. So we'll have one of those, and then come back here to, on use, gain three protection next scene. That's not bad. Combat start, gain three protection. I mean, throwing that card at people looks... might be fun. I don't know if that stacks. It'd be funny if it did. But okay, that seems to work out. I don't think we're gonna have infinite numbers of these, though, because we're gonna be using... that. We got another Jin's page. We're gonna be using the Yang's pages to increase power here. We're finally out of oinks, which is kind of sad. Also, we didn't get speed, did we? Also, yeah, Walter's pages are dug in back then. I forgot about that. Kind of do need speed, that would be nice. We can't actually start stacking that like a motherfucker. It's one bleed, and then... It was... Julius page, right? Yeah, slash damage. So hang on here, back the fuck up. I think we can do... I don't think we... This is funny, but I don't think we really need that. I'd trade speed. Okay, 4 and 4. Well, there you go. Just enough space. Thing. Am I going mad? Oh, right. I'm already on the page. What am I doing? Sorry, it's getting late. I only have one more of that. Our last guy's gonna be somewhat under-equipped. Going to be using Yang's page with, fortunately, no further upgrades. So Cooper here is going to be somewhat under-equipped. Should be able to pull... Unfortunately, I think we're out of speed dice, too. What a shame. Yeah, We appear to be out of speed dice. Out of speed dice. That's unfortunate. All right, so what we'll do is we'll probably... Let's do something with the musicians, I think. So I think the musicians buffing people, and also there are a lot of buffs in this deck that, the musicians and Seo's group actually have a lot of buffs that give people, you know, defense stats. So, I don't think we're going to be... Yeah, we can't actually use more than one improv drumming. Oh, well. I don't have a lot to throw at this, though. Sure. Just slash and... Have any more Julius pages? No, we do not. We're out of those. Yeah, just... That's not really helping. 10 HP. I mean, sure, why not? That's not great, but it's something to put there. So you're gonna be doing buffs. Okay, so we'll save Rules of the Backstreets for the other people. We're gonna need a zero, obviously, but buffs. Because I know we can do buffs. Ah. Shortula. I might actually need that for... I forgot about that. I don't think I saw that one, or I wasn't paying attention. Bleeding. Not necessarily bleeding, but let's see here. Give random strength. One strike to a random ally. Silent Mist protection. That's for themselves, but by hell. Gain 3 protection. Everything else is shit. Okay. All So we'll just have a bunch of twos and zeros, ones and twos there, just for this attack buff somebody just in the middle of all the chaos. That's gonna be better than somewhat of a recompensation for not being as good as everyone else. Of bully. So tailoring is another interesting concept. I guess we'll give one guy tailoring and see how if that actually plays a part. We'll give Ramirez tailoring. So we'll have that there just to see exactly if that really amounts to anything. Pages. Clean up. And let's see here. The other one. I suppose this is help everyone. I don't know if it does. Really isn't anything else we can do in terms of putting in more bleeding cards. Well, there you go. At least we can get in there and then ones. Slash attack the scene. Sure, throw that in. Then, Shocker Blade. I don't know if that's gonna work out, but we'll have enough things to throw at the enemy, finally. We've got plenty to throw. So we've got bleeding units and burning units and guns, finally. That took way too fucking long to set up. But okay, so, Mr. Puppeteer. Let's try this again now that we're actually properly equipped. So we've got our wonderful first plan, which is throw the guardsmen at them, and then actual backup plans with actually decently equipped units. All right, let's see if we can manage this. They're weak to slash, but we should be able to punch right through them. Counter dice. Oh boy. Counter dice are displayed in yellow. These dice will be saved until an enemy attempts a one-sided attack. If a counter die wins a clash, it will be recycled if there are dice left on the opponent's combat page. Okay, so it's a... So I can roll... Okay, so if I do a counter die... I hold that die just in case a one-sided attack comes my direction. So it's kind of like a dodge, but it'll sit there. Okay. More game mechanics. Fun. Yeah, it's just a bunch of noise. Okay, let's, well, one at a time, boys. Just like training. Enough to put this guy in the ground, so we're gonna swap off to another die, and then this man back here, we'll take another shot at this guy and we'll see how this all works out. out. Okay, they're brittle as fuck. Okay, one down. Staggered. Unfortunately, now we're out of attacks. Ow, though. Okay, so won't need very much to get rid of these guys. So that'll probably kill him. Send that flying back there. That one, I don't have any more attacks. And we'll just shoot up this guy, I suppose. Staggered. That didn't kill him. Oh no, enemies actually getting their dice. Oh no, enemies actually getting their blocks. The one fucking, the one absolute ruin of my plans. Enemies actually getting the clashes. Oh no. So two. You should be able to put the man down with one. Fortunately, we don't have any more twos. It's going over there. Going over there. Right, so this probably won't kill him, but will do a lot of damage. Well, he's already dead, so that's saved. Okay, two down. No downsides. This will pierce attack. Reduce the max stagger resist to the target button. Well, what do you fucking do? Who's actually gonna survive? You. So unfortunately, we're gonna have to block some of these attacks if we want our guys to actually still operate. Unfortunately, they're going right for the fucking jugular, so this is gonna be kind of an issue. You, we could at least match head to head. We're gonna lose a man. And all of those attacks fucking just got eaten up. Okay, staggered, good. We're taking turns getting staggered here, but we're still alive and we're still actually operating. That's great. The guard are doing at the best that they possibly can under these circumstances. Okay. That's probably enough to kill the man. All the other damage goes elsewhere. Shame I don't have six. But I've got enough for two. And we're staggered. Man's dead. Fantastic. All right. The laughing powder. Because the game's over. It doesn't really matter. Okay, so that's a two. He gets speed. Fantastic. Okay, so I could use this to redirect that attack. Though it's not really going to matter. We're all just going to dump as much fire on the enemy as humanly possible. Well, let's see if we kill him before he does any damage. Oops, you fool. Actually, he's got guts, so he's actually still alive. You picked the worst target for that. Nets has guts, so that means that if he takes fatal damage, it gets reduced by 25 for one scene. So he'll survive one scene unless he gets hit by something amazingly powerful. So yeah, all right. So the guard, well, they're expended now, but that was kind of the whole point. Well, I hope they don't get any passives that allow them to heal or anything like that. But we've got plenty of time. Well, we could still make a dent. The whole point of this fucking group is make a dent. Kill the enemy or make a dent. So do you guys have any wonderful passives I should know about? Blunt dice, when speed is over, speed is 5 or higher, deal 1 stagger damage with attack. Ow. Nope, okay, so they're gonna take permanent damage no matter what we actually manage. Okay. Why are you, okay, I guess I'm clicking on him, right? Why are you glowing? Oh, right, because you're being clicked on. All of my dice suck! Wow, okay, dump as much damage as possible on the one guy. Fighting retreat. I say retreat, but, well, this is, we're going to die, horribly. We're not retreating, no one's retreating. We're gonna stand on this spit of sand and die. That's a stagger, good. That's another stagger. However, when everybody else gets their turn, we're fine. And that man's dead, okay, we managed to kill one. Killed two, that's even better. We're all going to die now. Actually, we might survive to do a little bit more damage. That guy's dead though. Ah! There's the bomb! On death, all characters take 50% of this character's maximum HP as damage. Well, next! Arm the bomb! Here we go, kids. Things get easier when you realize you're never gonna see the next sunrise. And we actually have enough for all of these attacks, that's fine. So that's gonna be, that guy's dead. Well, he should be dead, right? That's gonna, well, I haven't actually selected an attack. So we're just gonna spray out as much damage as possible. That guy's probably, he's gonna be an oof. So I guess we'll assure the kill. If I happen to die horribly, well, everybody else is gonna die with me. So we'll just spread the damage out as much as we can. It is a good day to die for the Emperor. Unfortunately, yeah, about that. Didn't actually get any of that damage in. That would've been nice. He's still alive. Bomb hasn't gone off yet. We can still do more damage. Actually, if I stagger him, does that mean I'll do more damage when the bomb goes off? Kill that guy. This is the end, my friend. Actually, no, he's still alive. Hey, sure, why not? Let's keep this going as long as possible. I don't have any more cards, though. I think I'm out of cards. No, I've actually got one left. How about that? Wow, way to fuck that up, Ness. And bang. And now they only have 19 health left. Actually, that guy has 16 health left. That's what the guard does. They do as much damage and cause as much dysfunction as possible. If they can't kill the enemy, they die and leave a massive, ugly dent in their forces. Once again, they serve their purpose. We can make them better over time, but they have served their purpose. Okay, so next, what do we do? I suppose we could just throw Hod at the problem, or Malkuth at the problem first to see exactly how burning does, because this could be rather quick. Send in the salamanders, yes. Tan Malkuth art when? Hmm? Okay, so we've got 3 dice. I'm gonna poke you. I'm gonna poke you real fucking hard. Like, oh my god. I'm just gonna take a swipe there, then take another swipe there, just in case we don't fucking kill you. Take another swipe over there. Yeah. This is, hey, I've got cards, yo, allies with, everyone has speed 2. Everybody has speed too. It's fantastic. I've got my entire team has speed dice, so this is a wall of pain going outwards. Ow, though. I've got way more attacks! Mind the br- he's already dead. Stop it! Stop it! He's already dead! Okay! So, yeah, okay, thanks to the guard for softening that one up there. But now we throw Malk at this problem, and if Malk doesn't do it, we'll send in Hod. Hod will probably do this, unless they have some kind of passive that makes them heal, but the Nimble Puppets do not. We'll see what the boss does. What's the deal with the boss? Okay. Speed, obviously. Concussion. On a successful blunt damage, deal 2 bonus stagger damage. Puppet skeleton. Okay, so they will take permanent damage. So, if Malk somehow fucks this up, we're still good. Actually, we got 2 attacks. So here's some burning. And here's some more burning. And then, I don't have the thing for that, but, right, so we've got a bunch of zeros. So the Binding Arms, why not? This is probably gonna be overkill. Okay, here's some burning. He's probably dead, but I do not want him to use that. Okay, it is zero. We'll just punch him, and then we'll have this guy back here actually do something of value. And we'll punch one of these guys. He's probably fucking dead now. Or crippled beyond belief. I really, really do not want him to use that mass attack. Unfortunately, all those hacks got no cell. Great. Great, he actually dodged all of those. Not good. Well, somebody's got staggered. Well, got nearly staggered. Twelve stacks of fire! They're barely doing any damage. Yeah, of course when it stacks up it hurts, but 14 stacks of fire! Yeah, Ashes, thank you! Fortunately, one of our guys got staggered, but yeah, still 9 stacks of fire. Fire good. Unfortunately, I only got 1 attack left, so let's just keep punching that guy directly in the fucking face. Which will, again, add even more fire. Sunset Blade, and forget about the fucking Turners. Fuck. Ten stacks of fire. 13 stacks of fire. Okay. He's actually only got 2 hit points left now. Now he's dead. Yep, that fire burned him. Fire good. All right, now we can move on to literally every other target. Now we can actually make some sense. Okay, so those guys are all attacking. Yeah, okay. That's a problem. Well, I can beat most of those attacks. We can just, redirect that. Have even more burning. And then she could just, Malk herself can just use Sunset Blade on who the fuck ever. Yeah, you. Poke. Our Pokey boys are getting really shit on with those dice. Good thing we've got excessive amounts of attacks. Fire. 13, 17, 20, 24, 27. Fire good. Oh, well, happy memories is also something we want to use, but I think happy memories are how much fucking fire we're stacking on people. Oh, well. That's nice. However, it's random, so oh well. Actually, yeah, tapping him once probably means he's fucking dead, so... Yeah, Sunset Blade. And, he has no other attacks. Unfortunately, Happy Memories did not give me the card that I wanted to actually get tapped for that, but oh well. There's that, and we have no other attacks. Please stop getting fucked over by losing dice rolls, please. He is dead. Okay, so we're taking casualties, but we're gonna be walking out of this just fine. Gluttony! Yeah, let's keep him out. Aha, six dice. Or actually, two dice, three dice. Crack a dawn. Hey, that finally comes up. Actually, we'll use that after, actually, no, we'll do. We'll have somebody go first, right? We'll have somebody go first to actually activate that passer. So we'll do that. And then right after that one, we'll down here and then proceed to slap him and fucking go with that. Make sure that guy dies. Well, use that and then use the focus pack. Actually, I don't think it's gonna matter, so well. We'll meet the attack, I guess, but... Oh no, she staggered. Damn! That's inconvenient. However, he got another giant stack of fire, and he's down a teammate. Well, it's gonna be good milk, but oh well. We'll manage. You and your fucking dodge. Okay, well now he's staggered. Well, we didn't have a chance to get, use gluttony, but there we go. Okay. Malk, please, if you would. All right, so we took a little bit more damage than I expected there, but that was, again, the strategy we wanted to go forward with. The guard goes forward and causes as much fucking disruption as possible, and then eventually will be worn down by the enemy. However, this is planned attrition. We are expecting to eventually lose with that team. They just do a fuckload of damage until, you know, by the time they lose. And then they'll be, then, you know, we come up with a fresh team with a, you know, a more sustainable, you know, way of doing things rather than just all guns, and then proceed to mop up the rest of the enemy. And in that, we had two teams back there. So, yeah, that works just fine. We need better gun cards, most likely. We could always have better gun cards, but that's exactly how I thought that plan was going to work, and it works exactly how I wanted it to. It just took, like, 45 minutes to set up there, actually having to micromanage everyone else's things. We didn't even see if Hod's bleeding shit, but 24 stacks of burn! Ooh! That works! I don't know if we're gonna get anything. Aside from that mass attack, we might get that mass attack out of those. But how's the story end here?
저 인형들 정신은 밖에 있었지?
Yes, in an incredible pain, Roland, most likely.
그런 것 같아. 책도 꺼낼 수 있었고 자신의 의지는 멀쩡했지만 인형실이 시키는 대로 몸을 움직이는 것 같았어.
Yeah, probably sucked a lot.
그들은 온전한 감각과 감정을 느끼며 그 모습을 봐야 했고.
그렇다면
맞아. 인형사도 뒤틀림이야.
Oh. That guy's not actually human. He's That That guy's not just an incredibly overpowered anime human. No, he's literally a force of nature. He was human once.
인형들은 그 부산물이고 자신의 하위 개체를 만드는 환상체도 많이 봤으니 납득할 수 있는 현상이야.
쎄 빠지게 돈 벌고 인형 취급당하는 꼴이라니.
난 인형들의 마음을 잘 알겠던걸. 나도 같은 처지였으니까.
저 인형들한테도 자유를 줄 수 있어?
Freed only in death.
인형사를 죽이면 인형실은 풀리겠지만 남은 건 누더기 인형뿐이겠지. 그 모습대로 살고 싶긴 할지 모르겠는걸.
Probably not.
그렇군. 역시 쉽게 복원할 수 있을 리 없겠지.
Alright, well, that's that. And I think, well, it's 11:30 here, so I think we're done for this evening. Also, so where did Tip's challenge go? Oh, we needed the book. Oh, okay, right, okay. So we needed to go get another Seo book. We kind of want to anyway, just for the sake of... Actually, that won't take too long at all. Hang on for a minute. Let's do a quick grind there and we'll wrap up for this evening. That will not take long at all. We shot her to pieces with just... with just nets. We could probably do it again with no problem. With your current build, you'll butcher her. Unfortunately, we can only use one team. Actually, no. Never mind. We get two teams, and they're set up. So, never mind. Didn't see that before, but yeah, now we could just do whatever. Yep, nope, just bad. Actually, let's see. I can't really meet all the charges. But I can't meet, well, I can meet all the attacks. But never mind. Let's actually see. Is this gonna make me avoid more damage? Actually, in that case, it did because I staggered the fucker immediately. I win, says the man with the guns. That's that, and then that's that. Dead. Still barely alive. Shame about his friends, though. Now he's staggered. It's kind of unnecessary, but well, he's dead now. Put him down, boys. Right, so we want more Seo books, so we're gonna have to kill Seo last. I'm assuming she, well, her cards, the cards are pretty good, but I want to see her passives and that'll probably help Han. So yeah, no, we could use another team if we happen to fuck this up. I don't think we're gonna fuck this up. But again, if the guard fucks up, that's just their lot in life, and then we come in with another team and finish the job. If we're gonna have multiple floors, why not abuse the fact that we have multiple floors? I would like to get some speed die in here for these guys, though. It'd be so nice that I would be expending ammo willy-nilly like nobody's fucking business, but I'd like to have some speed die here. Ah, fantastic. So you get an indiscriminate fire, and you get an indiscriminate fire. How fun. So, yeah, Miss Sayo, shame about your bodyguards. The henchmen can no longer hench if you disable their hands. Actually, why am I doing that? Those are expendable. That's expensive. You actually might need the extra oof there. You've got 7 hit points. You're done. Well, make sure. Well, actually, I'm out of light, so well. That other guy I'm not so sure about. We gotta make sure the man's gonna fucking die. Yeah, he's dead. Good, fantastic. I remind you all that, as threatening as Seo's attacks are, Nets has guts, so he will survive the turn that she tries to kill him. Okay, so now that we're at this situation, Lay it on, boys. Doesn't matter. You just in case we fuck up. Bomb arm. Yeah, just in case she's not actually attacking him. Actually, he will die. Ooh, that's a... She's going to die, though, so it doesn't matter. Nope, he shrugged off the bleed there. He's fine. Again, I think he could have autoed this fight. Probably. There was really no challenge here with this. We did this the first time, but the thing is we just absolutely murked Seo before she could do anything at all. Which is funny. However, it meant that we didn't get her books. Fine. Everything's fine. Again, that fucking Oscar's guts is fucking great. That ability to just say, no! Sorry, you will not be doing damage to me now. We only got two books of Seo, though. Well, okay. We're probably gonna run that again because it's really fucking easy, but let's burn the books because I want her page. I want to see what her page does, and I want to see if we can get multiples of it, because it would be very nice to have some support for that. It'd be nice. Hey! We have to do the grind again when we play again, but hey! What's the thing? Speed. Nice. That'll draw two more pages at the start of it. Nice. Slash dice power. Very good. And then razor strike. That's not what I expected, but that's still very nice. I will be taking that. I will use that very well. Having good luck. But also, yeah, let's have a look at that that mass attack card over there. Let's see if we can... I don't want to do that fight again, so we're not going to go full ham on expending all of it. Actually, we don't have to do that at all. I mean, all of these abilities kind of... Actually, the counter ability is kind of nice, but we don't actually need to do that. Never mind. We don't actually need to use the weighty puppet. Because I think, I mean, the puppet page is there. I don't think it's very good, though. So, I mean, I suppose. Sure, why not? The page 2, I guess, might... be okay, but I kind of want the mass attacks and that counter. That'd be nice. Didn't get it, but I got this. Okay, good. So, okay, that's the counter. Where's the mass attack? Fresh flesh again. I think, yeah, it's just repressed flesh. Yeah, okay, and all these cards are... rather mediocre. I mean, that's a good... That hurts. Huh. They're draw ones. Good, okay. That... Restore two light. That's good. So those are... It's nice to have more of those, since we don't really... We only had a handful of those from Seo. The ones that allow you to restore two light on use instead of just one from the zeros. All right. So... I don't think this is actually a mass attack, but the counter is very nice. Reduce power of the target's current defensive die by 3. Deal 3 stagger damage to the target. Fun. have a couple of those on hand. Because we have three, we can actually, put that team on that if we want blood damage. There we go. Actually, give that to Yesod. Yeah, Actually, there was the other one with the other counter? Right, that was automated movement. So give that to Yesod. That'd be good. Repressed flesh will remain top tier for the entire game. Interesting. I think Yesod will probably make use of that, because blunt. Because it's all blunt. Like, fuck, what are the stats of that, real quick? Okay, that just deals you get one free card out of that, and you deal a shit ton of stagger damage. And you also reduce the enemy's defenses by one. And you get a counter, which means you just get a free attack. Well, you get to, roll at an enemy who's attacking you that's one-sided. So you get a free, save and a one-sided attack. It's a three, obviously, but we also have a bunch of things that give us more light, so putting this on Yesod and having them be the, Unga Bunga beat stick is probably... That'll work. But, okay, ladies and gentlemen. Also, do I have any more? I do. I got it in one, I guess. Alright, so... Hot over here. We're gonna have to do some reworking here with Hot stuff, with actually getting Seo's page in here. So that's more busy work, but it's nice to have speed 2 in there. Actually, we already have speed. So another thing that, we could actually give Cooper back your speed, I think. Right, do we have any? Yes, okay, so you've got speed. You do not have, okay. So Cooper could be a little bit better equipped. Hod can have, a kimono and a very revealing, chest line and the ability to pull a shit ton of cards all of the time. Actually, we could probably do this we could probably work this out to the point where she can keep drawing cards and basically be able to do whatever the fuck she wants on whatever turn she wants all the time. That actually might be nice. Fonto getting sucked into the loop of perfecting the teams. Well, the guardsmen are perfected in terms of theory. Honestly, they could be better, obviously, but we're going to need these teams to be good in order to get on with the rest of the game. So you're gonna have to spend some time doing this, but the blessed thing about the guards is that they're very simple. Their plan works, and if it doesn't work, they're a bomb. So they're going to make the next team's job very easy, even if they happen to fuck up and die. So there isn't much more you could do with that, aside from making them do even more damage in their burst segment before the glass shatters and they die horribly. I wish there was a way to boost, Teardrop and maybe make it even more fucking effective to nuke the entire field, but, that's about it. There's really nothing, aside from giving them better, gun cards, that's it. They don't need more advancement, so if we stick with this, perfectly fine. I mean, many a guardsman inconvenience cosmic horrors with their final grenade, yes. Yes, the horrifying warp chaos monstrosities had it real fucking good. Their plan was going real good up until that one guardsman back there missing a leg holding a melta gun in their general direction had a thing to say about it. And that's basically what we're working with here. So we could make them do more damage, but that's about it. Their role is perfected now. We will not have to change them, most likely. The other teams can go back and forth, and we'll find some funny ways to actually work these guys, but we're gonna need to have something that kinda sorta functions a bit on every level in order to make it through the game, because obviously if the game's good, it's gonna make you utilize all its mechanics, and thus, actually make the challenges that it gives you something of a challenge. If it forces you to reutilize all the mechanics, this is how you get complex things that require skill work. So obviously they're going to give us odd problems down the line, but if we make sure all of our teams are equipped the best that we possibly can, or rather, relatively, I'm not min-maxing here all that well, I'm just kind of throwing things together that seem right, so I'm not min-maxing the shit out of any of this, to the extent that you probably could, but as long as they're acceptably well-equipped, we'll make it through the game with very little issue, unless the dice happen to fuck us up. We'll see what happens in the later parts of the game, but, we seem to have at least a working first team in there to burn a hole through the enemy formation, and if once they run out of steam, oh well, they've done a shit ton of damage, and the rest of the teams will have no issue getting rid of the rest of them. You know, finishing the task and completing the mission that they started. So, that's that. So we got one thing that works. Let's see if we can get the other things to work, but that's for next time. Ladies and gentlemen, it is nearly midnight again. I have been your host, Fontaman. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed the stream. I will see you next time. Enjoy the rest of your evening.